Back, it's another Wednesday night. We are doing Shoot Your Shot Wednesday. If you're single, go ahead and click the request button. Have good energy, good lighting, do not disturb, airplane mode, connect to your Wi-Fi, put the light in front of your face. It's late night edition. No questions are off limit. Okay, I even want people to come on and ask some wild and crazy questions. All right, let's shoot our shot. All right, let's get this going. Let's get it going. I am going to go to, let's see who's in the queue. I was trying to get the people who were there first. Daryl, I'm coming to you, Daryl. Daryl, I'm coming to you. There we go.
Yes, I'm over it. Yeah. Sometimes it has to be like completely over it. Like completely. Let me find out. Instagram did ban me, okay? Let me find out. Let me find out. All right. Finally, we're able to get somebody. Hello, hello, hello.
Hey.
How you doing tonight?
I'm good. I, too, have been drinking, so.
Oh, what you been sipping on, friend? What you been sipping on?
I had some Crown and Coke.
Crown and Coke. I can't drink dark liquor in public. I can only drink dark liquor in the house. I've learned at this age. So, you in the house, so you be good.
I'm in a hotel, but yeah, same difference.
But you might. No. You might sneak out the hotel. I don't know.
No.
So, you know, you did a video not too long ago telling people that you were single, and then you put like this crazy disclaimer at the end of it, and I reshared it. I thought that was so cute. I thought it was also really good, and I think it's smart for people who are single, like if they're looking for love, to just like put it out there. So I would say, look, congratulations. Did you go on any dates from the post? Did anybody hit you up? What's up?
They did. I didn't. It wasn't given.
It wasn't given what you what needed to be gave.
Not at all.
Okay, well, hopefully we'll find somebody for you on here. Now, is your name Caden?
Yes.
Okay, good. Caden, where do you live?
Houston, Texas.
Houston in the house. Now, mm-hmm. Caden, are you a shooter?
Am I a who to what?
A shooter.
What is a shooter?
You're not a shooter. You're not a shooter. So the name of the show is Shoot Your Shot Wednesday.
Oh.
So, yeah. So people who watch the show, they're shooters.
Oh. Okay. This is my first time. I'm not going to lie to you.
Okay. Well, I always miss it because
I would. I'm not scared to shoot my shot if that's what you asked.
Exactly. That's what you doing.
Oh,
yeah.
Got you. Heard you. Yes. Okay. Yes.
What do you think I was talking about, Caden?
You saw my face.
I saw your face.
Like, wait a minute.
You're like, wait a minute. Look, the people are shooting in the comment section, people. Show them who if you're a shooter. Look, they're shooting on your face, Caden. Okay.
Oh. Okay.
You might like that.
Well, all right. I do a little bit.
All right, so it's National Coming Out Day as well. So if you could briefly tell me your coming out story.
Well, which time? This is why I skipped coming out day.
Right. You're like, I got to come out here, come out here. Give us one
of
your coming out stories, but make it brief, though. We want to know.
I came out and I told everybody, well, I came out as gay, as a gay trans man. On Facebook, and everybody lost their minds and people wanted to fight me.
Oh wow. And, so you came on Facebook, you came out.
Mm-hmm.
Oh wow, that's awesome. That's awesome. But like you said, people were not receptive. It sounds like they were angry.
No, this was 13 years ago.
Uh-huh.
So back then there weren't gay trans men, there weren't bi trans, especially not black.
Mm-hmm.
So I was like one of the first out, and they really wanted to fight me. Like they wanted to jump me, in the gayborhood in Philly and all types of shit. It was crazy.
Well, I used to live in Philly. I understand. It's kind of, you know. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yes. Well, thank you for sharing your story. Okay. Okay. So, how old are you?
I'm 37.
37. At least that my camera is kind of foggy. Does it look like that? Let me see. I got some tissue. Let's see. Let's see. Is that any better?
That's better.
Thank you. Yeah, thank you. Thank you, people. Thank you. Okay. All right. You said you're 37. How tall are you and about how much do you weigh, Kaden?
I'm 5'5". I'm like 210.
5'5", 210? Okay. And what's your zodiac sign?
I'm a Cancer.
Cancer. Okay. That's, somebody said, watch your mouth about Philly. No. And I lied. There were no lies told.
Philly is the ghetto.
There was no lies told. Philly is rough AF. And y'all know that.
Yes.
I know that.
Yes.
Come on.
Yes.
The women are harder than the men.
You're not lying.
I would fight a man in Philly before I would fight a woman, okay? Because the woman probably would drag me down the street and break something. I don't need any broken bones, okay? Listen, chicks in Philly, you just be like, ma'am, I'm sorry. I'm sorry.
I'm sorry. I apologize.
I'm going to go cross the street. I'm just going to get out your way. I ain't shit. Yeah, whatever. Yes, I'm a punk. I'm going to walk away. Now, dude, I would fight. Not a chick in Philly.
Yep.
Yes. Okay. This ain't about Philly. Okay. So you said Cancer? Cancer?
Yeah, I'm a Cancer, yeah.
Okay. Cancer. Now, the people want to know, are you team top, bottom, side, verse? How do you get down, Kaden?
I am a bottom who likes to pretend that I'm verse.
How do you pretend that you are verse, Kaden?
Because I'd be liking to eat butt and stuff, but like, I'm like, I'll talk, but like, I'm not trying to put in all that, you know what I'm saying? I just
sounds like a chore.
But I'm like I'm an aggressive bottom.
You're aggressive, you know? Bottom who likes to eat cakes.
Yes.
Okay. Listen, I think the people in the comment section will like it, and this is spicy night, so no questions are off limit, Kaden. So
that's fine.
You know, be ready for it. Okay.
Okay.
All right.
That's fine.
So you are a, more of a bottom. Okay.
Yeah.
What type of work do you do?
I work for myself. So I'm a trans advocate. I'm a keynote speaker, DEI consultant, author, reproductive. I work in reproductive justice as well. Mm-hmm. And I am a content creator.
Oh, great. Love it. Love it. They said we love aggressive bottoms.
Yes.
I'm afraid. It gives something's gonna get broken. A muscle is gonna be pulled.
Yeah. Absolutely.
You say, I'm sure you have hurt someone before. You probably like
I've hurt? I don't know.
Broke a bed? You ever broke a bed having sex?
A bed, a couch. Yeah, I
broke a seat. You look like it. It looks like it's aggressive, and you're gonna hurt somebody. Oh my god! Okay.
I mean, somebody asked what content? PG-13 content, like social media content, not Twitter or like none of that.
No OnlyFans. No OnlyFans. Okay. Yeah.
No.
Okay. What's your Instagram handle? Spell it for us, Kaden.
It's Kaden X Official. KAYDENX. OFFICIAL.
All right, you all. This is Kaden. Kaden lives in Houston, Texas. Kaden's 37, 5'5", 210 pounds. Is a Cancer, team aggressive bottom. Is a trans advocate. Does content related material. Does everything. If you all have questions for Kaden, use the question function or put them in the chat. You want to come on and ask Kaden a question? Just wave. It is late night edition, so y'all can ask Kaden whenever the hell you want to ask, okay? Just keep it spicy. All right. Now, do you want to get married? Do you want to have children?
I have two kids.
Oh, okay. How old are your children?
3 and 9.
Oh, you got little ones. Okay.
Yes. Yes, I have two kids. Mm-hmm. I'm not having any more kids, so don't hit me up with that foo-foo shit, because no, I'm not. Yeah. I'm not having no more damn kids.
No more kids. No more kids. Okay.
I've been married.
Okay.
And divorced, obviously. Mm-hmm. I'm not closed off to getting married. If I am dating, I'm definitely going to be dating with intention. Mm-hmm. I'm not interested in wasting time at my big age.
Okay.
And yes, I'm trans. Everybody keep asking, am I trans? Yes, I'm trans.
Yes. And this show is for everybody. And the LGBTQ plus IA, keep going down the alphabet, okay? Any age, any race, any size, you can live wherever you want. It's open to everybody. You see the gay flag back there? You see it? You see it? Okay, people. So you have a 3-year-old, a 9-year-old. You were married. Are you open to getting married again?
I mean, sure.
Okay, but no more children. You know what? No more children.
Hell no. No, absolutely not.
He's like, get someone else to do it.
Now,
what about what city does the person you date? Like, do you want to date men, women, trans, everybody? Like, who do you want to date?
I date men, okay. Trans men, and cis men.
So cis men and trans men. Okay.
As long as you identify as a man.
You say you a man, then Kaden's like, sign me up, okay?
Right, yes.
Now, what city do they have to live in?
I mean, I don't really care as long as you, I mean, if you're broke and you live far away from me, so don't even bother because I'm not flying you out nowhere.
My husband hates when I say that word, broke.
Well, if you ain't got no money, sorry, hubby. If you're financially challenged, I love Butch Queens.
I think Darius has a question for you. I think if you wave in the comment section, that means you want to come on and ask a question. So Darius waved. I sent him a request. Someone said, do you like Butch Queens?
I do. I love Butch Queens.
Okay. We'll see if Darius accepts. Oh, he didn't. So listen, people, if you wave in the comment section, that is a signal that you want to come on and ask a question. So don't wave. Don't wave. I know you want to say hi. Just say hi. So you prefer them to live in Houston. They got money and they can fly back and forth. That'll work for you.
Yeah. I mean, as long as they can, they're not expecting, things to be one-sided, then I'm fine with that.
Okay.
How
long have you been divorced?
Since 2016.
2016. So it's like finalized paperwork. You're not attached. You're not living together.
No. I live by myself.
You got to ask nowadays. They be like, oh, I live with my ex, and he live upstairs and I'm downstairs. I'm like, what?
Right. No.
Go get an apartment. Okay.
Right.
What's a good age range? What's the youngest? What's the oldest you'll go?
I think the youngest, like trying it, is 26. Oldest, I would say like 40, 42-ish.
Okay, 26, 40. Now y'all gonna have to bear with me. It's late night edition, so that means Lamont has been drinking. So
yes,
it is what it is. We gonna keep it going, okay, people? All right. What do you like as far as like body size? You like thin, thick, chubby, muscular, football build? What do you like?
I definitely tend to go for slimmer dudes, but I've been like inching towards like, daddy kind of,
like a dad bod.
Like a dad bod. I'm like, I like, I don't know. I just like handsome black men.
Okay. Somebody said we knew Lamont. Whatever. Now, do you have shared custody?
Yes, I co-parent.
Okay, they co-parent.
With both of my kids.
Okay. Mm-hmm. They're asking the questions. Do you like black, white, Hispanic, Latino, Asian?
Who
do
black. You
like? Black. Okay. What's black. Your ethnicity?
I'm black.
You're black. Okay.
Yes.
Now, are you into monogamy, open relationships, agreements? What do you like?
I'm into monogamy, mostly. Mm-hmm. I'm not closed off to polyamory, but only ethical polyamory.
What like, is ethical not, polyamory? You
know, meaning that there's open lines of communication. There's no lying. There's no disrespect. It's not a free for all. Like, you know, people ain't bringing diseases home and violating people and things of that nature.
So it is, I got to clearly talk about it. Communication.
Yeah.
Whatever rated K, they're like, Lamont, you've asked these questions already.
Yeah.
Whatever. Okay. If y'all have questions for Kaden, your light's doing something weird. Yeah. If you have questions for Kaden, put them in the question function or wave. You come on. Let's see. Since you're 37, why date someone that's 26? Why so young, Kaden? Are you trying to rob the cradle?
That's crazy. I said 26 was trying it. I said that's like really like stretching it for me. I actually prefer 30 and up. But what I've learned is that age does not equal maturity, and it does not equal emotional intelligence. So maturity and emotional intelligence are really important to me. So I've learned that older men tend to be very set in their ways, and they don't be trying to hear about learning like people's love languages and things of that nature. And I can't stand that shit.
Yeah. So you want a guy, if he's older, that he's curious about life and still curious about learning about himself, evolving, and not like, oh, this is the way it is. And...
Right, exactly.
Okay. All right, let's do another question they get. Kaden is not Native American and white people, okay? That was somebody else. That was somebody else, okay?
Yeah. I'm black and black, just black.
have you had surgery?
I've had plenty of surgery. I had surgery on my nose, on my knee.
Mm-hmm.
I've had a couple of C-sections. What surgery are we talking about? Now, if you're trying to ask me if I have a penis, we can talk about that when you're ready to put your mouth on it.
Yes! When you're ready to put your lips on it, then you ask that question, okay? Okay. Let's see what other questions. What are your red flags?
Lying for no, especially for no reason. I can't stand a no reason ass liar. Like, I can't stand that.
You lie when the truth will do.
Right, exactly. I don't like dirty fingernails, dirty socks, mismatched socks, bad hygiene. Those are super red flags for me.
Mismatched socks.
Plenty of people, and I cannot, as a grown man, I need you to have on clean matching socks. No sense of humor is a red flag for me.
Mm-hmm.
Damn.
It's the spirit.
It ain't me. I'm in this.
It's the spirit.
Okay.
It's the spirit.
Wait a minute.
Someone wants to know, do you spit or swallow, Kaden?
Hold on. Let me move to the light.
Right? Oh, you said, move the light to answer. Do you spit or swallow?
Swallow.
No drops left?
Mm-mm, no. We're not wasteful. We don't waste over here.
Okay. The clean nails, I get with you also. Like, yeah, clean your nails. Let's see. Who would you want to go that far with him not knowing if... Oh, my goodness. People, we don't have to ask about body parts, okay? Y'all can talk.
You did say no. In their defense, you did say nothing was off. Topic.
I did say that. Thank you. I did say that. Shame on me for opening up the floodgates.
Yes, you did. You did say that. And so nobody is going to be going that far with me without knowing. But I have a 3-year-old that I gave birth to.
Hello, people. Hello. All right, let's keep going. Let's see. How many kids do you have? You have two, right?
Yeah, I have two kids.
What are some of your hobbies, Kaden?
Really, right now, I just focus on working and taking care of my kids, if I'm being honest. I go out to drink every once in a while. I might go out and hang out with friends and go to a restaurant here and there, but really I'm focused on my business and building it.
Yeah. This is, how long were you married?
I was married for 5 years.
Okay. Okay. Corey wants to know what makes you moan, meaning like what sexual position makes you moan?
I mean, all of them, if you're good at what you do. But if I have a preference, I mean, I'm partial to doggy.
Oh. Hmm. Okay, people. Apparently, if you have a small dick, doggy style is the best position for you to do because it gives you like a little bit like 3 more inches, people. FYI.
Really?
FYI.
That I didn't know.
Yes. That's what they say. That's what the research says.
Oh. Wow. Okay.
So that's why you probably like it, because it feels much bigger.
Oh, you know what? That could be true.
You know,
although I'm not a size person.
Switch up positions. You'd be like, oh, it feels different this way. Oh, it feels.
Yeah, yeah.
Oh, that's why I like it this way, because it's hitting.
Let's go back
right
to.
Right, right.
Yeah.
Now, if you got a little one. And it's little, ain't no position gonna work.
Okay. Don't hit me up.
Yeah. You said what?
I said don't hit me up.
Don't hit you. Like, what's the smallest penis you would you like, oh no, this is a no. Like I've seen some small penises in my life and I was like, oh, this ain't gonna work, bro. Like.
The smallest that I've had, was 5 and a, that actually did something was 5.5.
I've seen smaller and I was just like,
yeah, see, no, I don't know.
You should have told somebody about that before we got this far.
Yeah, that's not fair. That's not my ministry.
You're like, no. Okay. Mm-hmm. Let us see you head to toe. You got to back the camera up, turn around so we can see you.
What if I didn't have no pants on or something like
that? That's fine. It's late night edition, apparently. It's, you know, you get this velour stuff on. Okay. You can.
Yeah, I was traveling. I just got off the plane, actually. Damn, I can't. This is as far as I can.
Yeah, you can spin around. We see you. All right, you all. This is Kaden. Kaden lives in Houston. Kaden is 37, 5'5", 210 pounds. Is a transgender man. He's a Cancer. Aggressive bottom. Okay. He has broken furniture, not IKEA furniture. So be ready for it. He works as a trans advocate, does some content creation that is PG and that like promotes, you know, positive thinking. He's open to getting married, has 2 children, a 3-year-old, a 9-year-old. Does not want any more children, prefers the person to live in Houston, wants to date a cisgender man or a trans man, any masculine energy. That's what Kaden wants. If you live out of Houston, you got to be able to travel because ain't nobody date nobody broke that can't fly back and forth. That's what he's saying. Will date between 30 and about 40, 42. Prefers slim, maybe dad bod. Prefers black guys, into monogamy, but might be open to like some ethical, like polyamory, amorous relationship. Tell us your Instagram handle one more time and spell it for the people, please.
It's Kaden, K-A-Y-D-E-N-X, C-O-L-E-M-A, no, that's wrong. Kaden X, O-F-F-I-C-I-A-L, Kaden X Official.
Thank you, Kaden, so much for coming on, going some dates, and keep us posted, okay?
All right, appreciate it.
All right, good night. Good night.
Later.
Bye-bye. Oh, let's rank Kaden first. Let's rank Kaden first, because I gotta get somebody together in the comment section in 2 seconds. Okay, if you think Kaden is dateable, put a 10. If you don't think Kaden's dateable, put a 1. I want y'all to rank. All y'all. I want all y'all to rank. What do you think? What y'all think? I think Kaden seems amazing. I did say I wanted to spice it up. Yes, yes. I see 7, 3, 9, 10, 8.3, 7, a 9. Super dateable. Okay, okay. I think he's averaging about like an 8. About an 8. Okay. Real quick. So I want the show to be fun. I want it to be fun. Have some good energy. Be a little messy. Be a little silly. But Art Seal, why do you watch the show? Yeah, that's your Instagram handle. Art Seal. Why do you watch the show? Every time you put a comment in, it's negative. Like, it's negative just because. I don't think I've ever seen you post a positive comment. It's always a read, a dig. And I've looked at your social media page. You have no room to talk about anybody. Like, no room. You should, like, really, I don't know, go to therapy, not watch this show, get a life. I don't get it. And that's your real page. And there are real pictures of you up there. Art Seal, S-E-A-L-E. I don't get it. Sounds pretty miserable to me. Sounds miserable to me. Let's keep the show going. Let's keep it going. I just be like, why? 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 Why like waste your time watching this show if you are only going to make negative comments? Have you looked in the mirror at yourself? Have you seen the horrible pictures that you posted yourself? Have you? Like, really, you should close your mouth and just sit back and chill. Like, chill. Oh, my goodness. I don't get it. I just want better for you, sir. I do want better for you. But you don't want better for yourself. Because clearly you're miserable. Maybe if you had some good dick in your life or some good ass in your life, a good man in your life, you might have a different take on life. But right now, it seems like it's the gutter for you. It's the gutter for you. All right. Oh, I can't. I cannot. All right. I am going to go to... Oh, we got a lot of people in the queue, so I'm going to keep it moving. I'm not going to be here fussing. Steve, I'm coming to you. Come on.
Hello.
How's it going?
It's good. You were on our show earlier tonight, Tag's podcast.
Yes, yes. So if you all know, I did a pre-recorded video with Steve for their podcast earlier today. How did it turn out? I didn't get to watch it.
You were very well received, Mr. Yes.
Oh, good.
Cheers. Drinking wine as well.
It is late night edition, so we are drinking wine. I'm definitely a little toasted. I just cussed somebody out because they pissed me off in the comment section.
Rightly so. I commend you for that.
Like, I want people to, like, here's the thing. People are putting their heart out. They're trying to find love. And some people just watch just to be trolls. I'm like, and then when you look at their page and you look at their account, sir, you are still stuck in the 90s. And I don't know what's going on. Yeah.
I hear you. I love the read. That was the library is open and you read them well.
Thank you, Steve. Steve, now you going to shoot your shot tonight?
I'm going to shoot my shot, yes.
Okay. Oh, they said, I think he deleted his count.
Uh-oh.
He just deleted his account. As you should. as you should. Like, yeah, go to therapy, then come back. Okay. Oh. All right, Steve, you are shoot your shot. Let's make this about you so you can find a great guy. All right.
Okay. All right. I'm in.
Ah, Steve, where do you live?
I live in New York City.
New York City in the house. What part of New York?
Chelsea, Manhattan, Chelsea, yeah.
Chelsea, okay, okay. And tell us, how old are you?
52.
Okay. How tall are you and about? How much? You're not 52, sir. Wait a minute.
I am 52. 1971.
I need to see some ID. I do not believe you are 52. I know.
It's,
I know,
it's around.
Don't show your ID. People will open a credit card in your name.
You know, thank you. Yeah.
52.
Yes. Yes. 1971. Yeah. Oh, well, thank you.
You don't look 52, okay?
Well, thank you.
What do you tell the, how old do you tell the boys you are when you meet them out in public?
Okay, so good question. Now when I go out and about, I actually am honest. I may be to a fault, but I don't go on the apps that much. But based on your interview on our show, I'm going to go on the apps and combine going on the apps as well as meeting people in person and shoot my shot on all of it. And on the apps, I say about 46. So I shave a little bit off.
Yeah, you could be in your 40s. I would say 40s. Like, yeah. Okay, yeah.
Okay.
But you're 52. Okay. Yeah. Bless your mother and your dad for the good genes, okay?
Oh, I will. Thank you so much.
How tall are you and about how much do you weigh?
5'11", 175.
Okay. What's your zodiac sign?
Capricorn. And my Chinese sign is the dog. I just learned that.
I don't think people know their Chinese sign. So your Chinese sign is the dog. What's something significant about the dog?
So I'm a metal dog, which you have to really know that I'm born in that era. I'm dedicated. I'm loyal. I'm a loyal friend. I'm a loyal partner. I hold the truth. When you tell me something, it's loyalty, I think, is the number one quality.
Yeah, dogs are loyal. So that's a good quality. People want loyalty in a relationship. Okay. Now, are you team top, bottom, verse, side? How do you get down?
Okay, so originally, years and years, total bottom. Over the years, as I've matured, I am truly versatile these days. Truly, and I mean truly, not versatile bottom. I'm truly versatile.
Well, Steve, let's do the calculation, okay?
Okay.
In the last 12 months, no. I don't want to know how many, okay? I don't want to know how many, but what percentage did you top? What percentage did you bottom?
I think I topped 60% of the time and bottomed 40.
Okay, it's given verse. Okay. That's how you ask a guy, like you go on a date with a guy and you'd be like, oh, I'm this, I'm that. You'd be like, really, sir? What does the math say?
No, exactly. That's the percentile breakdown. Yeah.
Okay, team verse. And what type of work do you do?
So I'm a full-time podcaster, podcast producer, so I produce.
Love it. Now, tell us your Instagram handle and spell it for the people because they're going to be wanting to send you messages. Okay, Steve?
Okay. I am_SteveV. I am _SteveV as in Victor.
All right. All right, you all. This is Steve. Steve lives in New York. He is 52 years old. We can say 40, maybe 45, but he is 52. He's 5'11", 175 pounds. He's a Capricorn, team verse, and he's a podcaster. If y'all have questions for Steve, go ahead, use the chat function or use the comment section. He said 60-40 was his ratio. 60% was top, 40 was bottoming. Keep up, people. Keep up. Okay. What are you sipping on over there, Steve?
It's a Grüner Veltliner white wine.
Oh, so, fancy over there. You fancy over there. Okay.
It's $10.99, but but it's good, Lamont. When you come to New York, I'm going to serve you a glass of it.
I may be having an event there soon, so I'll keep you posted.
Okay, yes, please.
All right, now, y'all got questions for Steve, use the chat box or the question function. Or you can wave and come on and ask him a question. It is National Coming Out Day, so tell us kind of like, what's your coming out story? Briefly, what's your coming out story?
Really briefly, in the 90s, it was in San Francisco, California. I was going to UC Berkeley, and I met a guy in the gym locker room. I know it sounds like a fantasy, and he was bisexual at the time. I'm using air quotes, yeah. But we had a whole thing. He had a girlfriend at the time. We played around with the threesome thing then, but ultimately I realized I had a major crush on him more than I had on his girlfriend, and I realized I was gay then. Gay pride.
So y'all were running a train on the girl, but you were really interested in him.
Yeah. We did a threesome thing, and you know, I was freaked out by the vagina and all, but I went there. And
you're like, "Well, there's a dick in the room, so I'm okay."
Yeah. But I think, yeah, it was 19 or the early 90s, and I never looked back.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Love it. They said, what made you want to switch from being a total bottom to being versatile?
Definitely maturing, definitely growing older and realizing, drawing younger guys. Some of the younger guys definitely were bottoms. And I realized, why have I clamped onto this bottom? It was when I was younger, everybody made me a bottom that I met. Mm-hmm. And so I realized it's more fun to diversify, and I have a nice dick and I would like to use it. And so, yeah, I just think versatility really is the key. And I'm not even just saying that. It's like, it really is fun to be that way.
I will tell you, Steve, people think I'm pushing this versatile agenda. They think I am. But, you know, I'm just saying, people, if you be a little more flexible, you have more options, okay?
Yes, absolutely.
There you go. All right, so do you want to get married? Do you want to have children?
Yeah, I think children, no. I'm okay on that. Although if I met somebody that had a child, I would be welcoming to that. Marriage, I think I want to just date somebody. And, you know, we did a story on the show tonight that two people married each other or got engaged after 7 years. And so I think it takes a long time to get to that marriage point. I don't want to rush into anything, okay. But I'm willing to date.
So take your time. Tim has a question for you. Tim, say hello. Introduce yourself.
Hello, my name is Tim. I'm from the South. Hello, Lamont, brother. How you doing, Steve? Because I got to commend you. You do not look your age. I got to commend you. Welcome to, you know, us older guys. They call us the wiser guys. But I got to ask you this. You're 51. Do 52, any guys...
52.
Excuse me. I'm sorry. You're 52. Any guy in New York, do they ever question you or give you problems because of your age or really show you shade?
Good question, and thank you so much for that. I think I get a lot of surprise and shock, and it's like, I think, get over it. People of color, like the three of us right now on the screen, are always gonna, I feel, defy our age. And so, while I think that I get a lot of people shocked by it, I really want to always move on from that, because it's like, I don't want the whole conversation to be like, oh my gosh, you look so young. It's like, okay, thank you for the compliment, but I really want, like, can we move on to get to know each other? Mm-hmm. And so I really try to push it forward.
Okay. So Steve, they were asking, well, not asking, there's a comment that was made that they don't think you respond to your DMs. Do guys send you messages and your DM trying to talk to you and you not respond back?
I mean, if they're doing it right now, I'm not.
Not right now, but like you, in general.
I'm a little, okay. So one of the things about being in your 50s is I'm maybe not as quick on social media. So I have been guilty of being a little slow to get back to things like that, which I should probably work on.
Oh, So that they called it right. Okay, but he's gonna work on it, people. Calm down. Calm down.
I am, yeah.
Tim, thanks
that's
for coming
all I
on.
To know. All right, peace.
See you later. Tim is a good friend to the show. I think someone else wants to come in and ask you a question. They're coming on for you, Steve. Let me see.
Hey.
Jay, I'm coming to you. Oh, there you go. Okay. I had to figure it out. It took me a moment. All right. Somebody said he's not obligated to answer. I agree. Hello.
Hey, how's it going?
I'm doing great.
So I the only question I have.
Can you introduce yourself, be a gentleman? Can you be a gentleman?
Oh, I'm sorry. My name is Jesus, and I live in New York. And I was just kind of interested in the way that you were delivering your answers. And I was going to ask you about, how people always talk about your age and you're beautiful and this, that, and the other. Do you feel like you are avoidant when, like, there's a lot of focus on more so beauty and materialism and things of that nature as opposed to substance?
Hi, Jesus. Nice to meet you. Am I avoidant when people focus too much on my age? Is that what you're saying?
Correct. Like, do you find you try to immediately slide past it and go on to something else that will lead elsewhere, but the weight of that, do you feel like you get it a lot to the point where, like, that's kind of like the lifestyle at this particular point, because people are always physical, like, you know, social media age, things of that nature. It's so much focus on, you know, the beauty or the trophy as opposed to getting to know you.
Okay.
And perfection.
Yeah. I mean, good question. In person, if it's, I meet somebody that's focusing on the age, I usually move it forward to getting to know the person. And 9 times out of 10, they're very open to want to talk, like, be real and talk, have a conversation about each other. And everybody seems to want to, 9 times out of 10, move on, which is really good. I have taken Lamont's advice and probably getting more involved in being online. So I'm going to see how that goes. I haven't had a lot of luck or experience online, so I'm going to start focusing a little bit more on that. So that remains to be seen.
Okay.
Got you. My AirPod just died.
Jesus.
Yeah.
Does Steve look like your type? Does he seem like a guy you would go on a date with?
Well, like,
as you said, you're blushing over there.
He's like a childhood dream, like, you know, Mario Lopez, like watching Saved by the Bell.
Yes, childhood like dream. Show.
That was like when I first learned that I was gay. I was like, that nigga is very beautiful. I'm sorry. The guy is very beautiful. But I find you very beautiful. And
wow.
Yeah.
Thanks, Jesus.
Feel like you as well. I also feel like I don't want to rush even a relationship. I'm really looking for a friend, which is why I was skeptical of even trying to request to join. But I just don't want to put an emphasis on marriage anymore or even relationship. I just want to let the wind blow wherever it may and not try to follow a script.
Yeah. Not try to get hit by a car either, right?
Well, listen, I would say hit Steve up, invite him out on a date. You always out at night walking somewhere, which I noticed. You're out in the streets, which is a good thing, because you can't find a man sitting in the house. You got to be out and about, okay?
That's what I'm saying.
Yes.
And somehow the DL niggas always love me. But well, I'm trying to be
coming on. Thanks for coming on.
Yeah, I appreciate it. Thank you.
All right.
Have a good one. Nice to meet you.
Thanks, Jesus. Yes, absolutely.
Look, Steve, you bringing the boys out. You bringing the boys out.
Okay, Lamont.
Oh, all right. Do you want to get married? Do you want children? Let me make sure I get these questions in.
So you asked that earlier, and I don't want to get married. I don't want to have children, but married, I'm open to it.
Okay, no kids, but open to marriage. Do they have to live in New York?
They do not. I travel a lot.
Okay, any city. Okay. What about age range? What's the youngest? What's the oldest?
Okay, 52 here. I'm open. I'm really open. And I want to have an open mind. But I mean, I would say, I hate to put limits on this. Lamont, can you give me a little advice on...
Let's start at 40. Let's start at 40,
yeah. Yeah, that's probably what I would have said, but yeah.
40, like maybe 55, 60.
Yes, exactly. 40 okay, to okay. 60, 65, yeah.
There's some attractive 65-year-old men out there, okay?
Oh, yeah.
Okay. What about body type? What do you like?
You know, more importantly than anything else, and I've really proven this of people I've met, as long as you're physically active in some way, shape, or form, I'm good.
Okay.
The last guy that I was hanging out with didn't really work out a lot, but liked hiking. I love hiking. I love nature. Mm-hmm. So, you know, that just shows me that you're into physical outdoor activity, and that means more than whether you're in the gym pumping iron every single day, even though I like to do that, but I don't need my partner to do the same thing.
Okay. They said you'll go down to 28 years old.
I'll go to 25, all right? But well, what are we talking about here?
We're not talking about screwing. We're talking about dating.
Okay. Right. I hear you. Yeah.
If he's 25, 26, you might screw him, I'm sure. But the date, we're starting at 40. Okay. Now, are you into like Black, white, Hispanic, Latino, Asian? What do you like?
The whole spectrum.
Okay.
My first boyfriend ever was Asian. I've dated Black, Latino for sure. Mm-hmm. And of course, white.
Okay. So open. What about like monogamy, open relationships, agreements? What you like?
I mean, at this point, if I'm going to date somebody, I want to start monogamous first.
Okay.
But if that, I have a sexuality podcast and we talk a lot about open relationships. So if it went down that road later, I am not a spring chicken. So we could have that conversation.
Okay. All right. Now, what questions I got for Steve? You can use the question function. You can use the chat function. You can wave. Come on, like two other people did. Ask the man a question. Let's see. Okay. They said you got a Black man on your wall. Who's on your wall?
That's Lisa Stansfield in the back. She's my favorite. What else have I got back there? That's our show in the back.
Stevie is shooting the shot. Stevie is saying, there's another guy named, his name is Stevie. He's like, hey, would you go on a date with him?
Let's meet him.
Inbox him. Hello. Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah.
DM me.
Yes. Let's see.
I like the name.
Where would you take men in your city on a date?
Where would I take them?
Yeah.
If the weather was good, I love a good walk. We have really great parks in the city. I would start with a walk in the park.
Oh, nice.
Yeah, start with that. And if things went well, I know if hopefully the person likes a cocktail, I know a lot of good cocktail bars that we could go to that point. If we want a bite to eat, I'm a foodie, we could move on to that. And see where the night takes us.
Okay. If you had a porn name, what would be your porn name?
Ooh, my middle name is Vincent. So it'd have to be, and my last name's Rodriguez. And I'm not doing so bad down there. So maybe Vinny Rod. How about that?
Vinny Rod.
Yeah.
So you know they're going to want to know how big it is now. You know they're going to want to know. You know they're going to want to be like, well, how big is it then? Like,
It's doing well. I'm all summer long, I was at the Naked Beach in New Jersey, and I got good look. It's not like the longest. It's more like thicker.
It's a girthy one. Is it a grower or a shower?
It's a grower, definitely. Definitely.
It's definitely a grower. Really grows. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Let's see what questions. They're like, oh my God, where is this show going? Do you like spooky season, like Halloween? What's your costume of choice?
So My costume of choice this year, actually, it's going to be twofold. I'm going to be a Ken doll, a blonde Ken doll because of Barbie.
Yeah.
But we're going to Mexico. My show is going to Mexico. We're going to do our show live there. But midway through the night, I'm going to change to Killer Ken. So I'm going to have a knife. I'm going to have Killer Ken on my chest. So from Ken to Killer Ken.
I love it. I can't wait to see. A bunch more questions. Let's see. Do you like femme guys?
I'm open. Yeah. I don't really have a preference on any. I've been with all kinds of types. Yeah.
Okay.
Absolutely. Okay. I'm totally open.
Is the tip pink or brown?
I'm a brown boy here, so it's brown.
It's brown, people. Y'all,
yeah.
It's late night edition.
It's late night edition.
Cut or uncut?
Cut.
They're surprised.
Born in the U.S., so yeah, Catholic, all that.
Okay. What else? How do you deal with breakups?
Well, in the past, not very well. But at a certain point, I think in your 50s, if you don't want to be with me, I don't want to be with you.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
And so I would rather part ways. Let's just be honest with each other. I think any relationship I go into now, I hope there's just going to be communication. And if it's not working, let's just... like, why are we killing ourselves? Like, let's move on so we could both find somebody that we really want to be with. So mm-hmm. I would think nowadays I would be really good. While I would be sad, I would be good with moving on. If you don't want to be with me, I don't want to be with you.
I love it. Love it. All right. So we got to see you head to toe, Steve. They said, Lamont, you're giving this man too much time. Listen, we're going to keep going tonight. I will probably out another bottle of wine. We'll see how it goes. But let's back the camera up so we can see you head to toe. Right.
I don't know that I can go that far.
Keep going back a little bit more. A little more. And to give it a little spin. Look, up. Oh, keep the bottoms on, though. Keep the bottoms
on. I'm giving the bottoms on.
He's giving y'all body over there, okay? He's giving body. 52 people. 52. You, if you drink water, mind your business, and be nice to people, you too at 52 can look this gorgeous. But if you are miserable, you know, nosy gossip, you will look like...
Thank you, Lamont.
...somebody else. All right. This is Steve, people. Steve lives in New York. He's 52, 5'11". 175 pounds. He is a Capricorn team verse. He runs an amazing podcast, produces it as well. He is open to getting married, does not want children. You can live in any city. He will date between 40, 60, maybe 65. Any body type works for him as long as you're active. He prefers monogamy, but if he evolves into something else, as long as y'all talk about it. And apparently, it is big, girthy, and heavy.
I won't.
Don't get me banned.
Okay, I won't.
Tell them your Instagram handle and spell it one more time.
Thank you so much, Lamont, for this opportunity. My Instagram handle is IAM_SteveV. IAM_SteveV, as in Victor. Thank you so much.
All right, Steve, thanks for coming on. You can go on some dates. Keep me posted and give us some updates, okay?
I will. Will do.
And go on a date with Jesus. Go on a date with Jesus. Yeah.
I love that. I know, right? I will.
Yeah. All right. Good night.
Good night.
All right, bye. Okay, people, are y'all enjoying the show tonight? Are you enjoying the show tonight? Yes, no, maybe so. Is it all right? Am I too rude? Is the vein popping out the head? I don't know. Are y'all enjoying the show tonight? Yes? Yes?
Y'all can rank him. If you think he's dateable, put a 10. If you don't think so, put a 1. Which I think. I see 10s. Come on, I want all 281 of you all to rank. Y'all rank him. Come on. I want to see you. What y'all think? What y'all think? Is he dateable? Would you take the man out on a date? Do you think he's a good match for somebody else? What do you think? I see 9s, 10s. Somebody said we need Tipsy Lamont every Wednesday. Y'all can't take Tipsy Lamont. Y'all can't. I didn't cuss somebody out. Y'all can't, okay? You can't. I'm sure that person I read earlier will probably report my account, but that's fine. All right, I think he is averaging about a 10. I always saw 9s and 10s and saying, yes, he's dateable, good catch for people. All right, let's keep it going. I will try to speed it up because I know y'all like, what? Charles, I'm coming to you, Charles. Charles, let's see if you're ready. Charles George, let's see if you're ready. Get out. Don't send me messages in my DM. They pop up on my screen, people. Daryl. So people who send me messages on the show, I screen record and I put this on YouTube. And y'all be saying inappropriate comments or like, oh, I like that guy and blah, blah, blah. Somebody sent me a message talking about, I want to see his tip. In my DM, because it pops up on my screen. So that is going to show up on YouTube. Oh. Charles, I guess you're not coming on. I sent you a request. I will go to the next person. Mm-mm-mm-mm. Oh, you want to ask him a question. You got to wave next time, Charles. Sorry. Mm-mm. Let's see. I'm going to go to GM something Scorpio. Let's see if you're ready. I think we got like 6 people in the queue. I'm going to try to get to all of y'all. Just, you know, let's do this. Are you accepting? Okay. Somebody said, Lamar, am I on the West Coast? No, I'm in Atlanta. It's just a late night edition. We need a disclaimer at the beginning of the show that you understand that we will be using your recording. Daryl, I'm going to come to you because you tried before. Daryl, I'll come to you. I should have brought the bottle out here. Hello?
Hey. How you doing?
I am doing great. How you doing tonight?
I'm good.
You know what? Instagram is trash. It is completely trash because I cannot see you on my camera that I'm talking to you, but I have a separate screen over here and it's coming up just fine. So let's do something real quick. Hang up and then send the request one more time, okay?
Okay, I'll try.
Yeah.
Because it was difficult for me to see the other request that you sent. Okay. I don't even know how I got this request.
Well, I didn't request you.
I sent the request 2 times, and then you actually accepted twice, and I didn't actually see the exception. And then even when this time, I don't know how this even happened.
Okay, hang up and then send it again, okay?
Okay.
All right, bro. I tell you, that's why I like YouTube better. I really like YouTube because it's less issues. I know we started out on Instagram and y'all like talking to each other back and forth and you can see the person's page immediately, but there are a lot of like hiccups with it. It's a lot of hiccups with it. It is a lot. It is a lot. It's a lot. Somebody said these comments just lit up like the 4th of July. All right. Can you hear me?
I can. Can you hear me?
I can, but I can't see you, but we're going to keep it going. It was like, hey, the other people can see you, so that's fine. Is your name Daryl?
You got it right. Yes, sir.
Daryl. Okay.
That's right.
Daryl, are you a shooter?
No, I'm not. I just discovered your show today. I've been watching you. I work from home, and I've been watching you from 12 until now.
12 until now? You binge watch?
Yeah, I've been watching. I've been reading your posts. I've been watching all your shows. I've been like, who is this guy? This is cool. I like this.
Where have you been for the last 2.5 years? We've been here for 2.5 years, almost 3.
I don't know. I feel like I've met your spirit before. I think I gravitated towards your channel because I don't think we've met, but I've met your spirit before. So I was like, I'm wondering how I know this guy. I don't know. But I moved to Atlanta like a year ago. Mm-hmm. I live in Atlanta, and I was in LA before I moved to Atlanta. And I don't know, I discovered you on Instagram. I have many friends that follow you. And then I just happened to see, I saw that a lot of my friends follow you. And I'm like, why are my friends following him and I'm not following him? And because if they like him, I should like him. So, and I do. So I'm like, cool. So here we are.
Look, well, welcome to the show. Okay. We're happy you're watching. Now, where do you live?
I live in Atlanta.
Oh, yeah. You said you just moved here, like, how long ago?
1 year ago.
Oh, do you love it, hate it? What you think?
Yeah, it is what it is.
It is what
I
it
love
is.
My house.
So is it Daryl or Gerald, they're asking?
Daryl. Like Sheryl Crow, Meryl Streep, Daryl, Merle.
With a D. I got a Pittsburgh accent. Sometimes... You know, it does a whole bunch of stuff. Okay. All right.
Sounds good to me.
Yes. So you live in Atlanta for about a year. Tell us, how old are you?
I am 44.
44. Okay. How tall are you and about how much do you weigh, Daryl?
I am 5'10 and about 200 pounds.
Okay. What's your zodiac sign?
I'm a Cancer.
Cancer. It's Capricorns and Cancers on tonight. What is that about?
It's like opposite. It's like the Cancer's here and the Capricorn's there, but we attract each other.
Where are you from? They want to know.
North Carolina.
Raleigh?
North Carolina.
Charlotte?
New Bern. The East Coast, it's about 2 hours north of Wilmington and about 45 minutes east of Greenville.
Okay.
5 hours south of Washington, D.C.
Okay. Now, are you team top, bottom, side? How do you get down?
Okay. So I'm versatile, but let me do a little caveat here. So if you're not black, I'm probably going to be a top. Now, if you're black, you know, I'm predominantly, I like the bottom for black guys, but I'm willing to consider some things.
Daryl, so you give the D up to the white guys and you give the cakes up to the black guys. Is that what you're saying?
Well, you know, I top black men as well. It's just that I'm versatile. Like, I've heard your questions before. You know, 80% of my life I've topped. But since I moved to Atlanta, it's like, you know, 80% of the time I bought them. So it's like, I don't know if it's necessarily a preference. It's just that I think a lot of black men, when they see me, they want to top me. And even when bottoms see me, they see me as a bottom. So they don't want me to top them. So it's like, it is what it is. So it's all good.
So the black tops see you and want to, you know, they want the cakes. And the white bottoms see you and they want the D.
They want the D, yeah. So
would you let a white guy top you?
Yeah. Well,
it's the hesitancy for me. It's the,
I mean, I've tried it. I mean, I would want a white guy to fuck me, but it's like, I mean, if you don't know what you're doing, then I don't want you to top me. So
you need well-experienced guys who are topping you.
Yeah, I mean, it's not necessarily well-experienced. It's just you need to know how to stroke. If you don't know how to stroke, I'm not trying to do like little bunny hops. It's like, I don't want to do little bunny hops. It's like, you need to know what a stroke is and what to do with all this ass. So if you, I'm experienced, so if you don't know what you're doing, then you can't get on top of me. I'm sorry.
Daryl,
you could bend over, and I'll show you how to do it.
Daryl, we're going to do this early. Let us see the cakes. Apparently, you have... Stand up, turn around. Let us see you. Like you talking
I don't
about.
Know if my black jeans will. I mean, do you want me to pick my pants out?
No, I do not want you to take your clothes off. You can just stand up and turn around. This is not OnlyFans.
I don't think this camera does it any justice.
You said the camera doesn't do you any justice.
I don't think I'm.
It's giving cakes. It's giving cakes. It's giving cakes.
I don't know. I've seen cakes in Atlanta, so I don't know. I if I was in LA, I'd be happy to show my cakes. But I'm in Atlanta. I don't know. These boys got some cakes. So
they're saying you are caked up. They're saying you're caked up. There you go. Okay.
I think most people when they see my cakes, they like it. So bottoms like my cakes too. So it's good.
And Daryl is saying you have cakes, and he is like cake king. So if he says that, y'all both at the same bakery. So y'all good. Okay. Well, let's continue with the questions. So you said you are team verse. What type of work do you do?
I work for the federal government. I have a full-time gig with USDA, and I also have a consulting business on the side.
What part of the government?
USDA, Department of Agriculture.
Oh, okay, USDA. Okay. Are you doing like administrative? Like what type of work do you do there?
Privacy and compliance. Okay. I do that full-time, and then in my consulting business, I also do it part-time. The part-time business is what I'm trying to grow.
Okay. So tell them your Instagram handle and spell it for the people so they are not DMing me looking for you, okay?
Daryl is here. D is in Delta, E is in Echo, R is in Romeo, Y is in Yankee, L is in Lima, I is in India, S is in Sierra, H is in Hotel, E is in Echo, R is in Romeo, E is in Echo. Daryl is here.
All right, you all, this is Daryl. Daryl lives in Atlanta. He's 44, 5'10", 200 pounds. He is a Cancer. Team Verse, he works for the federal government at the USDA. If y'all have questions for Daryl, use the question function, wave, if you want to come on and ask him a question, or put in live chat. Okay, people? And some odd reason, his IG handle is also not listed there. So, Daryl, go ahead and type in your Instagram handle or just say hello and I'll pin it so people can see it. Instagram is the ghetto right now. It has so many flaws, errors when you're going live. So usually if you go live with somebody, they're supposed to show up live with you as well. It's not showing up for him right now. So just say hello and I'll pin your, there you go. I will pin it for you all. Boom, there you go. All right, Daryl, do you want to get married? Do you want to have children?
I would love to get married. Children, maybe not.
Okay. What's a good age range?
I'm thinking about 40 to 50. 40? Maybe a little bit, give or take. They don't have, it's not that stringent, but that's the range.
Okay, yeah, because you're 44. Does the guy you date, does he have to live in Atlanta?
Oh, no.
All right. What cities would you date in?
Well, I travel back and forth between Atlanta and L.A. all the time. That's where I just moved from. I go to Texas a lot, Houston, Dallas, Austin. New York would be a city, D.C., goes to Chicago.
Okay.
I live right next to the airport. It ain't nothing to hop on a plane to go see my man.
Okay. Hey, people, he said the cities. Oh, my husband just bought a badge. Thank you. He's in Vegas right now, so he's helping one of his friends celebrate their 50th birthday. So I'm happy you're watching from over there. What about race? What do you prefer? Black, white, Hispanic, Latino, Asian? What you like?
I prefer black. Hopefully he's African and hopefully he's from Nigeria. But
wait, say that again?
I said, hopefully he's Black, and hopefully he's also African and from Nigeria, but Black is fine.
Are you Nigerian?
No, but I like dark skin, tall, beautiful, purple skin African guy. I love Black skin. It's just beautiful.
Okay. Okay.
Beautiful. But okay. I'm open to all races, though. It's just that I'm Black. I love Black people, so it is what it is.
Darker the better. That's what you want. Okay.
I love Black.
What about body type? What do you like? Thin, thick, chubby, muscular, average? What you like?
Well, I like pretty much on the muscular thick side.
Mm-hmm. Muscular thick. Okay. You have do you prefer like monogamy, open relationships, agreements? What do you like?
I'm definitely down for a monogamous relationship, but I'm open to understandings, potentially polygamy a little bit. Sorry, I've been drinking my Hennessy and Coke.
Yes, no worries. You probably want polyamorous relationship, not polygamy. Polygamy is like the straight people. They have like a man all these other women.
Polyamory.
Yeah.
But I'm looking for monogamous, but I'm sexually fluid. I'm open to a lot of different things. I'm a freak, but I want to be a freak within a monogamous relationship, if that makes any sense. I want a partner, a connection.
Okay. All right, people, if you have questions for Daryl, use the chat function. You can wave. I want somebody to wave. Come on, say hello to him. They said the Henny got you Hennying.
Hey, it's open. What do you want to ask me? I'm ready.
Let's see. Now, they spicy tonight. Do you like your salads tossed, Daryl?
Yes. I like my salads tossed, and I like to toss salad. I'm very good at it.
That's what he said, people. That's what he said. What's the significance of the barcode tattoo that you have?
This is my birthday, which is June 27, 1979. And it was just a symbolism of, this was my very first tattoo. Mm-hmm. I got my first tattoo when I was 40, actually this year, in March of this year. I waited a long time. Mm-hmm. I wanted to make sure that I didn't get a tattoo because it was trendy. I don't believe in following trends.
Uh-huh.
I'm not a trendy person. I do what I want to do. And it just took me a long time to make sure that I actually wanted it. I got a temporary one. I loved it. It's like a barcode, like you scan, you're like a product, and then it's like, oh, that's Daryl. So I'm like, yeah, that's cool. I like this. So I have another tattoo in my leg too. So
Okay. Someone wants to know, what does that mouth do?
Well, it talks a lot. I talk a lot of shit. Unfortunately, when I drink, I talk even more shit. When I'm at work, I talk shit. I eat ass. I'm not a good dick. I mean, I'm be honest. I'm not really a good dick sucker.
What do you mean?
I don't enjoy.
What do you mean?
I'm sorry.
What do you mean? No one's talking.
Well, I mean, I'm about to say something really boring. But I have an issue with my jaw where my jaw doesn't open all the way. So like trying to put something in my mouth and like keep it in open for a long time, it kind of like, it's very tiring, so I'm not good at it. And I have a gag reflex, so, you know.
You got to practice, Daryl. You got to practice, okay?
And I'll, you know, for the right person, I'll do whatever. You know, if he's, you know, listen.
Go ahead and stick a cucumber in your mouth. Just let it hang out there for a little while.
I can practice. I mean, I ain't never got no complaints because I don't believe in teeth.
Yeah.
You know, if you put it in the side, you won't get no teeth. I can tell you that. if you down on me, if you get teeth, I'm about to pump you in the head. I better not feel teeth. I don't like teeth.
No teeth. All right. Let's see. What are your hobbies? They want to know after that question.
Well, I have a home gym, so I work out quite a bit. I bought a house last year, so I'm constantly working around the landscaping and trying to fix stuff around the house. Mm-hmm. I travel quite a bit. I go to festivals, concerts. That's pretty much what I do.
Okay. We got some more questions. What is your political affiliation?
I'm a Democrat, definitely, all the way. However, I don't believe in hating someone because they are a different political party. I want us to be unified. We're all here together. I think this is a broadcast in the United States. But if we're in the United, I don't know if it is or not. But in the United States, we're Americans. I think we should embrace each other's differences, but not hate each other because we think something different. However, yeah. I'm definitely a Democrat. I support Democrats all the way down the ticket.
Did you vote for Trump?
Absolutely not. I don't vote for Trump. I did not vote for Trump, and I will never vote for Trump, and I don't support voting for Trump. However, I do acknowledge his charisma and his stardom that got him to that position and how he fooled everybody to vote for him. And he continues to do that.
It's more like his white privilege, I would say.
Well, I'm not gonna argue with you that. Yeah. I agree with that.
Yeah.
In our society in general, we love fame. We love famous people. We give famous people credit, more credit than they deserve. And just because you're famous doesn't mean that you're smarter than anybody else. But he was an apprentice, you know. People loved him. So
he should have stuck to that. He should have stuck to that. And that was it. That should have been it. So there are people who are asking a question. They're like, your tone, how you speak, where is the background? They're like, where do you get your, I don't know the word. What's the word I want to use? I don't know. Where do you get your speech from?
I don't know. You know, this is interesting. It's like, this has been like my, what do you call it? It's like an evil thing that has haunted me all my life, where people hear the way I talk and they, for some reason, when they hear me talk, they take it and think that they're like, oh, you think you're white or you talk white or whatever. And they assume that I only like white guys. But it's like, you don't understand that I've been with most of my sexual experiences is black. I love black men. Yeah.
But it's your dialect or your vernacular. That's what they're wondering. Yeah.
I have a bachelor's degree. I have a master's degree. My master's degree is in public affairs. I've given a lot of speeches. Mm-hmm. I was in the military for 10 years. I've lived in 18 different cities. So I've never, even though I'm from North Carolina, I actually lived in so many different places that I don't think that I actually picked up an accent. I just moved here from California. I was in California for the last 5 years.
There's probably a combination of a lot of things. That's what it probably is.
Yeah. I've been around. I've never picked up a slang, and this is what it is.
Yeah. Yeah. Okay. Let me see what other questions we got. Let's see. Would you be into a light-skinned black man? Would you date a light-skinned black man?
Yes.
Yes. Okay. Let's see. Someone said it's late night edition. Take your shirt off if you are open to that.
I'm not in my prime shape, but I'll take it off.
he's Whatever. Open to showing you all. Okay, I can't see anything right now. I have to look at my other screen to see like what's going on. But if you want to show them, go ahead. Let's see. This is not a strip show, but. They want to see what you're working with. There you go. Okay. One more question for you. Y'all like it spicy, people. I know y'all. Nard, I blame you. What is the freakiest place you have ever had sex, Daryl?
Probably on a dance floor. On a dance floor in some place in LA.
You had sex in a dance club? Like, how'd that work out?
Well, actually, probably in like two. I was actually at the Abbey. If anybody knows what Abbey is,
I know about the Abbey. Yeah.
I had an orgy in the. In the bathroom stall, I just kind of invited into. I saw what they were doing, and they invited me in there, and I fucked the bottom with the rest of the guys. And then there's a lot of parties they have in LA, like these big warehouse dance parties. And I like fucked a few guys on the dance floor.
He's being transparent, people. Y'all have done, some of y'all have done the same thing. So, yeah.
I'm not scared of anybody's judgment of me.
Right, right. Okay, Daryl, tell us, I'm sorry. Let me give you a rundown. You already showed us everything, what you look like, so we don't need you to stand up and do twirl again. This is Daryl. Daryl lives in Atlanta. He is 44, 5'10", 200 pounds. He's a Cancer. Team Verse, he works for the government at the USDA. He's open to getting married, no children, will date between 40 and 50, any city, LA, Atlanta, Texas, New York, he's open to it. Prefers black guys, guys who are average, athletic, healthy, and prefers monogamy. Free spirit over here. Tell us your Instagram handle and spell it one more time for us, please.
It's Daryl is here. D is in Delta, E is in Echo, R is in Romeo, Y is in Yankee, L is in Lima, I is in India, S is in Sierra, H is in Hotel, E is in Echo, R is in Romeo, E is in Echo. Daryl is here.
All right, Daryl, thanks for coming on the show. Thanks for being open and go on some dates. Keep us posted, okay?
Thank you.
All right, all right. Good night. Good night.
Tonight.
What'd y'all think? What'd y'all think? What'd y'all think? Is he dateable? Put a 10, not dateable, put a 1. Nord, I blame you. Janard, I blame you. Foolishness. Do you all think he's dateable? Are you going to rank him? Ronnie says, is that a million? Is that a million? Prince? 7.5? 7? 4? What'd y'all think? Well, why y'all ranking? Hold on, I need to get a refill. Let me just go grab the bottle. I'll be right back. It'll probably take me 2 seconds. Okay? And then I'll put somebody in. Who's next in the queue? Who's in the queue? Oh, I think Art did want to come on. I thought Art was watching. So when is Art coming on to co-host? I think he did click a request earlier. He's in Vegas right now, though. Hold on. I got to grab my wine. It's late night edition. We are turning up. Okay? Hold on. All right, I'm back. I think y'all are... I'm not taking a shot. No. Definitely not. I think... Y'all not ranking him. I don't think y'all really ranked him. Yes, tweet. Can I get a refill? There we go. All right. All is well. Let's see. Okay. We are going to go to... Oh, Art. Come say hi. A 10? What'd y'all think? Hello.
Hey.
What's going on?
What's up? How's it going?
It's going pretty good. We're doing a late night edition tonight. Oh, you sipping too? Look, cheers.
Cheers.
Oh, the tweet didn't sing that song. I don't know who sang that song, people. I don't know. How was Vegas so far? Say hello to the people.
Hello, people. Happy Wednesday to you. Vegas is great. We're going to the little Usher after party in a bit.
Just don't be dancing with Usher, okay? You know, he like dancing with people's wives and husbands. So, well, not
Usher. Usher can get it. Usher can get it. I won't risk it all, just half of it.
Please no. Please no. He ain't worth it. He ain't worth it, okay? He ain't worth it. He ain't worth it. Not Usher, please, okay? They said they wanted to co-host.
I need to come and co-host. I haven't been on in a while.
It's been a whole year since you've been co-hosting.
Has it been a year?
Yeah, it's been a long time.
I won some money today gambling.
Oh, how much?
$20.
I ain't no money, okay? If you win $1,000, then yeah, okay? If that $20...
$20, that's it. So, anyway, I just wanted to come on and say hello. I miss you. I love you.
Oh, I miss you too.
Hello, Instagram.
$20, people. He won $20. $20.
Right.
All right. Good night, babe.
Okay. Love you. Talk to you later.
Okay. There we go. All right. Who is next? Let's see. Let's keep it going. Let's keep it going. Anthony, I'm going to come to you, Anthony. Let's see if you're ready, Anthony. Right, he probably won 20,000. That's what he probably won. I'm gonna look at. I got that bank account. Listen, I got his bank account, Anthony.
Why am I on here?
Because you clicked the request button.
I wanted to talk to the other dude, but I wanted to get him together.
What, you're supposed to wave. You're supposed to wave like, "Hey, bring me on."
Oh, my bad. My bad.
What guy did you want to talk to?
The last one that was on here.
Oh, Daryl?
Yeah, Daryl.
That lives in Atlanta?
Yeah.
Daryl, if you're still watching, send a request. Let me see if I can find him. Hold on. Let me see. I think I might be able to remember his Instagram handle. Let's see. You like Daryl?
No.
You're like, no. Then what do you want to talk to him about? There he is. He's coming back. Let's see. He's coming back. You know Daryl? Hello, Daryl. How you doing? Welcome back.
Hey, how you doing? What's going on?
I can't see nobody.
You can't see him?
I can't see anybody.
So Instagram is the ghetto. I can see both of you all. But for some odd reason, Instagram has glitches. Right. But he's here. So.
Somebody told me to be nice and log off.
Ask you. Ask a question.
Be mean.
I'm not going to do it no more.
No, go ahead and be mean.
I ain't gonna be mean to you.
Let us know how you feel.
What?
Let me know how you feel. I like criticism.
No, I'm gonna be nice.
No, don't be nice. Tell us what you came all the way up on here to tell me what you wanted to say.
The people are asking me to be nice, so I'm gonna be nice tonight.
Fuck the people. Tell me what
I'm gonna be nice. I'll tell you what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna invite you out and I'm gonna talk to you.
No. You saw this on an open forum. Say it on an open forum.
They're asking me to be nice. I'm gonna be nice.
No, don't be nice. Be nasty.
Do y'all know each other?
I don't know him.
What is it?
I don't have no criticism for you.
Did you have a question?
No, not anymore.
Okay. Well, thank you for coming on, Anthony. Daryl, thanks for coming back up to, you know, but we're not doing that energy.
I'm going to be nice.
I'll see y'all both. Goodbye.
Bye.
Yeah. I'm happy Anthony censored himself, okay? I'm happy he censored himself because my thing is like, hey, you're going to come in here, ask people questions or probe about what they said. If you think they capping or some bullshit, ask questions. But I don't want y'all being mean to people. Go do that on a different show. Yeah, so thank you, Anthony. Thank you. All right, who is next? Let's see. Ray, I'm coming to you, and then Galen, I got you next. Ray, I'm coming to you, then Galen, and I see Jules as well, but Ray, I get you. Let's see. Daryl's cool people. He seems like good energy, he's honest. Some of y'all, you know, want people to lie to you. Daryl was telling you who he is. Hello, hello, hello.
What's up, man? How you been?
I'm doing pretty good. I'm doing pretty good. How's Seattle?
It's rainy, actually, tonight.
Isn't that normal for Seattle?
Yeah, this time of year, yeah.
I feel like it rains there all the time.
Yeah, just got into its rainy season.
Oh, okay, 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 okay. Are you shooting your shot tonight?
Yeah, why not?
Okay, Ray, okay. Now, Ray, are you single?
Yes.
Like single?
Yes.
Ain't nobody gonna be like, that's my man, we dating and we talking, why is he on this show?
No.
Last week, there were some great guys on the show, and then someone DM'd me and was like, wait a minute, I thought I was in a full relationship with that guy. Like, one of the guys who was, I'm not gonna say who it was, but they like were in a exclusive relationship, and the way that he broke up with him was him coming on the show.
Oh, wow.
Which I think is horrible and immature.
I agree.
Yes, yes. But you're single, Ray, right?
I agree. Yes.
Okay, cool, cool. Ray, are you a shooter?
Yeah, I am.
Tell the people, right? Tell the people.
I am.
All right, so you're in Seattle, right?
Yeah.
So I met Ray when I was in Seattle when I did an in-person version of Shoot Your Shot Wednesday. Had a great time. If you've not visited Seattle, go there. The air just it smells fresh. I feel like
there's black people in Seattle.
There are black people there. Yeah, there are black people there. Yeah. It smells fresh, less pollutants. The food is good. You got to go in the summertime, not in the winter, though. Yeah. Yeah. So you're in Seattle. How old are you, Ray?
I'm 38.
38. How tall are you and about how much do you weigh?
I am 5'6", about 185.
185? Okay. Now, what's your zodiac sign?
I'm an Aquarius, man. Come on.
The only sign that actually matters in life. The rest of them exactly. Just get in line, okay? Just get in line. Okay, okay. What now, are you team top, bottom, verse, side?
I'm a fully verse side, if that makes sense.
It does not. It does not.
So by default, I'm fully verse, but I don't need penetration, you know, but it's nice. Mm-hmm. But typically, you know, I stay in the versatile range.
Okay. Okay. So versatile. So you give them the D, you give them the cakes, or you, I guess, playing around with each other.
All of it, man. It's like no rules. Just bring what you got and we'll figure it out.
Okay. Okay. Now, you got to do the calculation, Ray.
Yeah.
What percentage of last
50-50.
Child, you even take a moment to even reflect on it. You guess I'm
already 50-50. I already know what you're gonna ask.
Is it really 50-50?
Actually, I mean it is. It is.
Okay. He is team verse people. Tell them what type of work do you do?
I'm active duty military, been in the Navy for 20 years. Got 3 more years and I'll be fully retired.
Okay, Navy, 3 more years. Listen, people, that's some good benefits. Okay. Okay. The gays can get married now. Okay. There's a pension involved and it's a whole bunch of stuff also with the Navy people. Okay. Y'all be dating these guys with no benefits and no plans and no health insurance, no investment. Oh, my bad. I was going down a tangent. Okay. So, but you work for the Navy. Okay. 3 more years. Yeah. Okay.
Yeah.
What is your Instagram handle and spell it, Ray?
I think it's RayJ_85.
RayJ_what?
85. Okay. All right, you all, this is Ray. Ray lives in Seattle, Washington. He's 38, 5'6", 185 pounds. He's Aquarius, the only sign that matters. Team Vert, our side, works for the Navy. Yeah. Tell us, what type of guy are you looking for tonight?
Man, you know, I don't have many demands, you know, be able to be a provider, provide for yourself, right? Have decent employment, be a good person, you know. If you have baggage, be honest about it. We all got baggage. Ain't no need to lie about it. Yeah, I don't have too many demands. You don't have to look a certain way. I mean, I want to make sure you go to the gym, right?
Mm-hmm.
But also want to make sure you like to go out and eat too. So I mean, balance, right?
Yeah, like to eat and work out.
Yeah.
They want to know, do you have Navy, Federal?
That ain't none of your business. More importantly, I got a good credit score. That's all y'all need to know.
There you go. Yes, credit score. Now, do you want to get married? Do you want to have children? Let the people know.
Man, probably no kids. Marriage can be a discussion, but I'm leaning more towards no kids.
Okay, so no kids, marriage, a discussion. Yeah. Why not? A man is trying to get part of those benefits over there, right? Why can't he tap in?
With the what? The marriage?
Yes.
I didn't say he can't. I said no kids. Like, kids is probably not a...
So no kids, but marriage, you say, is a discussion. It's not like...
We can talk about it over dinner or something.
Have you been married before?
No, I haven't.
Have you been engaged?
No.
Kind of engaged?
No, not engaged.
Did someone put a promise ring on you?
Something like that.
Yeah, but, that's what people be like. I fucking hate, excuse me, I fucking hate a promise ring, okay? My thing is like, piss or get off the pot. Like, do the engagement. Or don't. Don't give me a promise ring to say, oh, I'm going to engage. I'm going to propose to you at some point. Okay. Mm-hmm. Keep that in your head. But I don't want a fucking promise ring. This, yeah, you know, that's for little girls who are promised to save their virginity for a man. Like, no.
Right.
Yeah. So whoever gave you a promise ring, tell them to go to hell. That's why they're an ex. Damn. Or did you give the promise ring?
No, I didn't give the promise ring.
Okay. I was saying. Oh, okay, my bad. I went.
That's too much.
Does the guy you date have to live in Seattle?
Yes.
Okay. Oh, apparently your IG is not showing up. So just type in hello and I can pin your IG handle so people can see you.
All right, hold on.
Yeah, okay. Promise rings are for controlling fathers who want to protect the sanctity or whatever of their child's virginity. It's a no for me. It's a no.
I agree.
It's a no. Ugh. It gives ownership. Ugh. Pinned comment. There you go.
Okay.
All right. Do they have to live in Seattle? I'm sorry. I forgot. I know I asked
that. I would prefer that, yeah.
Okay. Seattle, okay. You might have to sign up for my matchmaking services to find a guy.
That's fine.
What about an age range? What's the youngest? What's the oldest?
Oh man, I would. That's really hard because I've met some very mature 20-year-olds and some very immature 30 and 40-year-olds. So it's the maturity for me, but. I would say lowest probably 30. I don't want to go under 30. And oldest probably, how old am I? 38? I would say 50, probably,
okay.
Maybe.
Yeah, 38, to, you know, 30 to 50, that's a good age range since you're 38. Okay. Mm-hmm. There's somebody said they're looking at property in Seattle.
Okay. All right. I hope they got some coins because the real estate market is crazy out here.
When I came to Seattle, I've been there a couple times. I thought it was gorgeous.
It is.
Now, what about like body type? What you like?
What, man, like I said, I want to be able to look at you and tell that you know where the gym is and you know how to use the equipment.
Okay. Okay.
Whatever that means, right?
Fit. Okay. So, yeah. Ray, they are saying that your Instagram pictures do not give you justice.
Oh, okay. Thank you. I think.
So what that means, Ray, that's what that means is you delete all your pictures on Instagram and take some new ones, like current ones, whether you're
those are all within this year.
Well, whatever you're doing, it's not showing your best light, okay? You got to find the light.
Lamont, are you calling me ugly on the low? Are they calling me ugly on the low?
No, they're saying you're gorgeous right now, but your pictures might be, I don't know. They might be a little fuzzy. Let me look at your pictures. I'll give you real.
Oh, people. God, this is embarrassing.
Yeah, let me see. Let me look at my Instagram on this one. Let's see. We got time. You get free dating coach right here. Okay. So your IG handle is, you said Ray?
Mm-hmm. RayJ_85.
I like the pictures. No, the pictures are nice. What I will say is, there's only one picture of you smiling.
Okay.
So you may need to smile more often.
Yeah, and I'm gonna smile. I like to smile.
If you're out and about, just be like, hey, take a picture of me.
Okay.
Yeah.
Because that's not weird.
It is not. It is weird. it's weird. It's weird AF, but it will get you the results that you want.
Okay, I'll take that for action. I appreciate it, Lamont.
I'm telling you, if you try to say I'm single, I'm marketable, you gotta have good content. You gotta have good pictures. But like, hey, I think I look cute today. Hold my phone, take a picture of me. As long as it's not a trashy iPhone, the pictures will come out in good quality.
Okay, I got that. Thank you. Appreciate it. Appreciate it.
Joey is saying, don't smile on pictures. No, listen. Black men have been taught to look mean, surly, emotionally, like emotionless. No, is that a word? Lack of emotions? No. People like to see like your energy, what your life looks like, where they fit in. Take more pictures like that.
I agree.
Yeah. Okay. Where are we? Race. What do you like, Ray?
You got to be a man of color.
Okay.
So, anything of color.
They're saying, Lamont, that's a lie. Listen, people, smile on your damn pictures. No one wants to look at someone trying to be too damn cool.
On the smile part, that's funny.
Just saying, smile on your pictures. You got nice teeth. You got a nice smile. Go ahead and smile on your pictures, okay? Oh, it's the iPhone slander. That's what it is. Okay. You said black are guys of color. What about like monogamy, open relationships, agreements? What you like?
I'm monogamous.
Monogamous. Okay. Mm-hmm. All right, people. What questions do you all have for Ray? Use the chat box. Let's see. What's your ideal first date and location?
I'm a hopeless romantic, so I'm about to do some, I don't know, some movie type shit, but I think you can't go wrong with a nice dinner and maybe like a walk on the pier, the beach, you know, something that is gonna promote a lot of conversation and getting to know the person.
I like a nice walk on the pier. I like a nice walk on the pier. I do not think first dates should be at two locations. One What's is that? The movie theater, and the second is a dinner date. I don't think that. I just be like, yo, let's just meet at the pier. Let's go for a walk. Or let's meet at the beach. Like, let's go meet at the park. Let's walk around. Like, I think if you do dinner dates, it turns into a job interview. Yeah, that's sexy. That. Yeah. Ray, I'm giving you too much dating coaching advice. Let me keep moving.
Hey, I'm taking it all in.
What questions I get? Yeah, somebody say, yeah, not a movie, people. Let's see. What other questions? What's your rank and rate in the Navy? Really?
I'm a E7. I'm a chief in the Navy.
You're a chief?
Yes.
Hey, chief, people. We got a chief. We got a chief over here in the Navy, okay? Y'all be like, Lamont, where are the good men? Where are the quality men? We got a chief over here. Okay. I don't know what an E7 is, though. Let's see. What other questions? Why didn't your last relationship work?
We were together for 4 years, but it was also long distance. Mm-hmm. And that was just too long. I couldn't do it anymore. So we ended things very amicably, if I'm pronouncing it the right way. But we still have love for each other. Nothing bad, but it was the long distance.
Okay. That was your last relationship?
Yeah, that was it ended in 2020.
Oh, okay. Mm-hmm. Let's see, what else? What's a deal breaker for you?
It's a couple of them. But one of the most important probably is lack of communication, or if the communication is off, that's not a good thing. If you're not versatile, that's not a good thing. Like, you can't be only one thing. You got to be fully versatile, like me. You have to have a job and be able to take care of yourself. If you can't take care of yourself, then that's a deal breaker as well.
Okay, I got some more questions. How heavy is the D?
I leave you satisfied. I mean, I don't have the biggest, I don't have the smallest, but I definitely leave you satisfied.
Is it giving boyfriend dick?
Yeah, I would agree with that. Hell yeah.
And for people who don't know what boyfriend dick is, boyfriend dick is not a 12-incher, it's not a 10-incher. It is something that is more manageable, but has some weight, gets the job done, and it's not super small either. It is just like something you can regularly ease into, and you can still have your walls at the end of the day. Yeah. Did I articulate that the right way?
You did. I couldn't have said it better myself.
Listen, what is husband dick?
I never heard of that one. That, I don't know. Is that a thing?
Husband dick, boyfriend dick, they're the same thing. Just one has a ring on it, the other one doesn't. That's the only difference. It doesn't mean it's more loyal, more committed. That's what it means. Okay, people. What other question? Are you out in the military, in the Navy?
Who needs to know knows.
Okay. Is there still like discrimination there? Like, if you were to tell people,
I mean, it's kind of like it's more like microaggression type shit now. You know what I mean?
Yeah, like, oh, that gay shit. I ain't with that gay shit, or like,
a little more subtle, but it's there. Okay. Just like racism, to be honest.
Yeah,
you know, in the military. So, yeah, it's all there, man.
Okay.
But I'm discreet, but I'm not closet or anything. I'm just discreet. So whoever needs to know knows.
Okay. Are you out to your friends, family members?
Yes.
Okay. Someone said, do you use a cock ring?
No, I'm not really into that.
Okay. Can the other guy use a cock ring?
I mean, sure. Yeah.
Cock rings give very much, like, you smash sausage in something and you just try to ram it in you, and you be like, oh God, like, that's just my little bit of judgment. They said, where can the gentleman nut at?
I mean, anywhere. There's no place is off limits.
Where's your favorite place for him to put the baby back in?
It depends on the moment.
Give me a moment that you were like, yeah.
I don't know, Lamont. Maybe my throat, my face. I don't know. Damn.
Like, Lamont, you're pushing me. You're pushing me. My throat, my face, right? Okay. All right, Ray, you got to back the camera up, prop it somewhere so we can see you head to toe, okay?
All right, let's see how we can do this because I'm kind of.
All right, let's see if this will work. Actually, let me go a little lower.
All right, and then do what now?
Back up. Give him a little spin. All right, you all. This is Ray. Ray lives in Seattle. He's 38, 5'6", 185 pounds. He's an Aquarius, Team Verse. He works for the Navy. He's open to getting married, does not want children. He prefers you live in Seattle. So some of y'all...
Or like what? I mean, West Coast at least.
Like LA?
Yeah, that's West Coast.
Oregon?
Yeah. Is black people in Oregon?
They're like five from there.
Oh, Portland. Actually, Portland.
Portland, yeah, Oregon, yes, Portland. Yes. Will date between 30 and 50, prefers guys of color, someone who's fit, prefers monogamy, and he's telling the people he has boyfriend dick. So that's what y'all want. Sign up for it. Make it happen. And he's a chief, people. He's a chief, okay? This ain't no someone who's struggling. Hit him up. Tell us your Instagram handle and spell it one more time.
All right, it's Ray, RAYJ_85.
All right, listen, go on some dates. I'm sure you will. Even if they're virtual dates, go on some dates and let us know, okay?
Thanks, Lamont.
All right. Appreciate you. Thanks for coming on the show. All right, bye. Okay, what did y'all think of Ray? I'm so mannish. Why? Oh, someone's sliding that DM. Go ahead and rank him. Y'all think he's dateable or not? I want all 280 of you all to rank him. What do y'all think? Yes, he has a car and can host. If that is the bare minimum of what a guy has to be dateable, you are selecting from the wrong pool of men. I'm just saying. If he has a car and can he host, is that all you're looking for? I'm just saying, you're selecting from the wrong pool of men. Okay, they said the most dateable guy tonight, he's just a little short. Y'all be worried about like height and whatnot. Okay, y'all can wait around for the 6'4", 6'1" guys to fall in love with you. And guess what's going to happen? They're going to cheat on you. If height is something you're so stuck on, keep waiting around. Just keep waiting. Keep living. Keep waiting. I've met him in person. He's taller than me. And I'm short, okay? I'm just saying, Erskine. I'm just saying. They'd be like, oh, I want this basketball player type build, whatever. Guess what? Everybody else wants him too. Mm-hmm. Everybody else wants him too. Everybody else is getting at him too as well. Stop sleeping on the short guys. That's all I'm saying. All right, we can keep going. I need like... say it again, Cecil. Let me pin this. Boom, okay? Thank you. I'm just saying. Get you a short guy. loyal AF, okay? We will get your back, okay? And if someone disrespects you, we will fight them, okay? Okay? On sight and scene. On sight and scene. Oh, he said, what? I'll be right back. All right, so we'll keep going, but I probably need like 10 more people to buy a badge for us to keep going because we've been on here for a while. We've been on here for over 2 hours, people. So, yeah, we're a little mischievous. We are. It's fine. I can handle that. I need like 10 more people to buy a badge, and then we'll keep it going. Okay? If not, we'll be done. We could be done. Uh-huh. Yes, and my husband is the same height as me. I wasn't trying to be like, oh, I need to date somebody who is much taller than me. I've dated guys who are shorter than me, my height. Height doesn't bother me. And like, I'm just, my thing is like, do you like what you see? Because some of y'all worry about like some of these superficial things. And when I was looking for a partner, for a husband, I wanted to find someone who like truly appreciated me for who I am. Not this perception of who I am, right? Because there's a perception of who I am. Yeah, I don't know. Yeah, I don't know. But I wanted someone that can see me and say, you know what? I love the fuck out of him. I got his back. I'm going to be here. I'm going to be committed. And that has nothing to do with what the person looks like physically. Whether a person appreciates you, loves you, is compatible for you, it has nothing to do with what he looks like. But for a lot of y'all, y'all like, oh, he got to look this way for me even to open up. And that is going to keep a lot of y'all single. I think the more and more that you look for the heart, the soul, if they fucking love you, if they're going to ride or die for you. Someone did a post about, oh, I'm not riding, dying for nobody. That's when you get off. No, I'm riding and dying for my husband, and he will do the same. That's when you find somebody, okay? Stop talking about, oh, he got to have a six pack. He got to be this height. He got to make this money. He got to have facial hair. All that shit changes over time. All that. It changes over time. So if the foundation is not there, if the companionship is not there, if you all don't enjoy each other's company, the space, like Art and I will sit at home in the living room acting silly. I wish there was a camera here. Like, we act silly so much because we enjoy hanging out with each other. People see us in Atlanta, we be out and about. Because I hang out with my husband. I don't need to be like, oh, I want to hang out with my friends. I do hang out with them, but I hang out with my husband because I like hanging out with him. Find y'all somebody who actually enjoys being around you. Like, literally, like, he can't. Find you a guy who can't wait to see you again. Who can't wait to talk to you again. The one guy was on, y'all were like, oh, y'all didn't like his beard. Ugh. I was just like, what? What? I'm, you know. Find your person. It takes time. It does take time. But make sure you have a emotional connection. Make sure that you look in that person's eyes. It's the wine, I'm sorry. That you see that they love you. And they're like, this is my man. And if anybody says anything negative about him, I will tear this place up. Okay? And got your back. All right, done preaching. Let's keep the show going. Okay? Okay? And consistency. Okay? Consistency. Okay. All right. We are going to go to Galen. Galen, I'm coming to you. Galen. Galen, I'm coming to you. And then Jules, I said I was going to come to you also. Galen, I'm coming to you. It is 1:10 in the morning on the East Coast. Yes. Hello. 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 Hello.
How you been?
Is this Maya Angelou? Maya, Maya, are you there, Maya? Maya.
No, Maya is not here tonight.
Is she resurrected? Okay.
Maya is not here tonight.
Did she? I don't know. I guess felt the ancestors were like, hey, Maya might show up, okay?
Nah, unless you see some graphic of her behind me, she's not here.
Okay, so this is just Galen. It's just Galen.
This is me.
How's your night going?
My night is cool. Okay. I just, you know, I tapped in when I got off work, so. Nice. I was like, child, I guess.
Now, you were on the show before, and you shot your shot. Like, how'd it go?
Yeah, it's been a little while. I don't, you know, I can't say that any, productive or, like great dates came from that. A lot of the guys who hit me up were like not in Atlanta. You know, and the few that I did, actually, I won't even say the few that I did go out on a date with. Like, I can't really say that it was a few. It was really only just like one. And
you went date with one guy in person in Atlanta.
From this live, yeah. Yeah. It was only one. And it was more of like I think we're better off as friends type thing.
Okay. Yeah. Well, let's shoot your shot again. Let's put it out there.
I suppose.
We got a new audience. These people in the comment section are looking for love as well. So they want you to be mm-hmm. yourself, and then they invite you out, okay?
Sounds good.
All right. So, Galen, can you take the do-rag off so we can see what's up under there? Give us Rapunzel. There you go. Okay. Cornrows with the little...
You know, cornrows with little bees on the side, whatever.
I
did it myself.
I saw your Renaissance outfit. I loved it.
Thank you.
Where did you go see her? You saw her in...
I saw her in D.C. and in New Orleans.
Mm-hmm. You better be a beehive, okay?
I had to get my double whammy. The New Orleans was the one that was planned. Like, New Orleans, that was the one that I got, like, you know, did, like, the whole verified Ticketmaster pre-sale thing. That was the one that I actually lucked up and got, mm-hmm. like, tickets for. But yeah. D.C., that was sort of, like, spur of the moment. It was like, oh, she's in town. I kind of just want to, like, I can't, you know, like, I was free. I was available.
It rained in D.C., didn't it?
Yeah. It rained tonight, and it was like, I mean, the show was delayed. Like, I think it was, she didn't hit the stage till like 10 o'clock.
Mm-hmm.
The show that I saw in D.C. definitely was a different show from what I saw in New Orleans. But it was still a good time.
The Atlanta show was the best show, I'm just saying. I know people that sure. went to other shows. I know people went. Sure. They went to D.C. They went to other cities. They were like, the Atlanta show, she did extra stuff. She gave extra time.
Yeah. But I don't know. I saw New Orleans. New Orleans was like, New Orleans, that was the second to last show. So that was like, you know, she did the full set. We got the big three, Thick, All Up In Your Mind, Drunk In Love, Dubai. We got Blue.
We got that.
Yeah, so we got the same show. Whether y'all got the better show or not, you know, if that's what you want to have, I'll let you have that, friend.
Okay. Well,
yeah,
you dropped your tie, though. Okay. Mm-hmm. So, Galen, you are in Atlanta, right?
Correct.
Okay. How old are you?
I'm 32.
32? How tall are you and about? How much do you weigh?
I'm 5'11" and I weigh about 173.
Okay. 173. Okay. What's your zodiac sign?
Aries. Can you see that? Yeah, Aries.
What's something good about Aries?
Aries are very honest. Aries are very loyal. Aries are action oriented. Mm-hmm. And we're also like the life of the party. Like, you know, I feel like Aries like to have fun. We like to, you know, sort of keep the energy high, keep the vibes high. It's also very much like, you know, don't fuck with me. You know, Aries are cool. I will say Aries are an acquired taste. Everybody, people either love Aries or they have a horror story about an Aries. So
your security guard personality comes out sometimes.
Yeah. Only when provoked, though. Only when provoked.
I'm
an evolved Aries, though. Like, I've done the work. So, like, you know, I'm selective about when I choose to, like, you know, let the horns rear. So.
Okay. Now, are you team top, bottom, side, verse?
I am a top.
What's the deep breath about?
Because I feel like I feel like we're in an age of top shaming or one side of the spectrum shaming. Like, if you're a bottom, people want you to be a verse. If you're a top, people want you to be a verse. Like, if you're not verse, nobody wants you. So I just feel like, you know, I feel like me saying that I'm a top is actually like working against me and not for me.
So
people, if I can be honest.
So yeah, if you tell people you're top, you think they don't believe you, or you think they'd be like,
it's a bunch of stuff. I mean, yeah, you know, like, because I'm also like, I'm not like, oh, what's up, bro? I'm not like, you know, super masculine or anything. And like, you know, I'm very much like, I have like all this personality, you know, like I try to be on the more comedic side of things. So I don't know. I don't know if people are convinced when I say I'm a top. And then they also like look at my body and they're like, why? You shouldn't be like, you need to be a verse, like blah, 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 all this stuff. So, you know, I'm like, I definitely think the verse agenda is real, and
apparently I'm pushing the verse agenda. Hey. But would you say you're more like a blouse or like a soft top if you had to put like a category?
I'd say soft top. I wouldn't say I'm a full on blouse. Like, you know, I'm not like, not like girl, hey, but like, you know,
not but girl, yeah, I'm hey, just me. But I'm like, just me. Hey, girl.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, I say own it, embrace it. And I will tell you, I did a video about this a long time ago, but I feel like the femtops are the ones that are winning, and actually the younger ones are settling down with the femtop.
Yeah. I mean, you know, I definitely think that, like, you know, soft tops are the way to go. If you are going to go with like one that's, if you are going to go with a top, like a soft top is going to be like, oh, I can give you vulnerability and emotional awareness and emotional intelligence and
some dick on the side. Like,
yeah, everything is so like uptight. It's like, you know, don't touch my ass, bro. It's none of that. Like, you know, I feel like I can be flexible. You know, like it depends on the person. Like, you know, I think I have verse aspirations, since I kind of feel like if I want to find myself in any sort of a long term thing, it seems like versatility is going to be the way to go. But for right now, and like the beginning phases of meeting anybody, I'm like, no, I'm a top. And okay. If I like you like that, and if you got boyfriend dick, then maybe we can talk about exploring the V side of things.
But now, in the last 12 months, have you given up any cakes? Are you a strip top?
Nah, it's been strict.
Okay. I gotta ask you, because someone made a comment on my videos. They're like, Lamont, you don't be asking the tops, are they strict tops and blah, blah, blah. I'm like, yes, I do.
Yeah.
Yes, I do.
Yeah, I haven't let anybody hit, but you know, I'm not opposed to, you know, some licking and kissing down there. And
what does the guy gotta do to hit?
Like I said, needs to be like beginner size. And also, I don't know, I think it's an energy type of thing for me. Like, you know, I'm not gonna wanna submit or like give myself in that way if I don't feel that sort of energy of like, you can take care of me in this way. And also too, like, you know, I feel like a lot of guys are like 0 to 65 in like the first three strokes, and it's like, you got to be patient.
Oh, so no jackrabbit.
Yeah. Nah.
No pound town. No pound town.
I think more than anything, it's like, I just have to feel safe. I have to feel safe and I have to trust you, you know, that's something that that's a way that I can open myself up or reveal myself to you in that way. Cause, you know, I kind of feel like that's like a really, you know, at least for me, that's like a really like that's a vulnerable place to be.
Okay.
You know.
Somebody said, damn, I want to marry Galen.
I don't know. I can't see. I'm not seeing any comments. Like, my comment stopped at that wine ain't playing tonight. So I don't know what the people are saying. I actually kind of like it that way.
they feeling you. They feeling you, sir. Okay.
Okay, cool. Cute.
Tell them your Instagram handle and spell it, please.
My Instagram handle is at the Galen J. Williams. That's T-H-E-E. GalenJWillians.
All right, you all, this is Galen. Galen lives in Atlanta, 32, 5'11", 173 pounds. He's an Aries. Aries is the wine, people. Mm-hmm. It is the wine. He is team top, okay? Oh, what type of work do you do? I forget.
I'm an actor by profession slash career, but as of right now, I'm a server at Red Lobster.
Oh, you at Red Lobster. Okay, so Red Lobster and an actor. Yeah.
Yeah.
Which Red Lobster are you at? Camp Creek.
Camp Creek.
Yes.
Camp Creek.
Yes. I tiptoe over there sometimes.
I literally just started this week. So, you know, it's very new, it's very fresh, but that's the gig for now.
No, and, I actually like that one. So it's, you know.
Yeah, it's cool. Yeah. It's cool.
They used to fight over there, but they don't fight no more.
So if I catch a flight over there, I'm gonna say thank you so much. This is great.
If y'all got questions for Galen, use the question function and the chat, or you can wave and say, hey, I want to come on and ask him a question, okay? Somebody said, I want some Cheddar Bay biscuits. Yes.
Here you go. Cheddar Bay biscuits.
It's already right there. Yeah.
I literally just took some home with me after the shift tonight because, I mean, it's like, you know, we have it so much and like, they just like, you know, throw stuff away. So I was like, take some home. That's so good.
Yes. Joey said he went to the Publix on over near Camp Creek and got nervous. Why'd you get nervous? I think the Publix over there is fine. Like, what? Because it would.
I don't know. Camp Creek, I mean, Camp Creek is like, you know, the clientele is the clientele, but it's not hood. You know, it's not dangerous over there.
No, it's safe. I thought it was fine. I go over there. Let me not tell too much of my business. someone's waving. Are you coming to ask a question? Let's see if they're asked. If you wave, that means you want to come ask a question. Let's see. The Camp Creek Publix is not ratchet. It's not. Now, if you said like the Kroger on Cleveland Avenue or
Old National.
Oh, National, then yeah. But
No.
Okay. Now, do you want to get married? Do you want to have children?
I am open to marriage and I would love to have kids. At least one, no more than three.
Hello.
Hi.
Hey, how you doing?
Good, I'm how
doing
are you?
Great. How you doing tonight?
I'm doing great. I just happened to come here. I was like, what is this? And I'm like, ooh. Somebody's here in these streets.
Wait, say that again, sir.
Somebody's here in these streets.
Oh, thanks.
You're welcome. Not feel bad, right?
Introduce yourself and ask Galen a question, okay?
My name's Zenard. I'm from Latonia. I'm an artist. And my question to you, Galen, is are you available, single? Don't got no boyfriend, don't got no nothing.
I am very single, very available, don't got no nothing.
Okay, me too. And another thing is, what's another question? Like, creepy? Who's creepy?
No, you're fine. Ask your question.
Okay, my question to you is, okay, what's your favorite food?
My favorite food, top of mind is pizza or macaroni and cheese. I love carbs, as you can see. So yeah, but I mean, I don't know. I kind of feel like a good go-to is like pizza. Meat lovers, pepperoni, sausage, bacon, ham. Meat lovers.
I know that's right.
What is your name again? What's your name?
Denard.
Denard?
Mm-hmm.
Denard, is Galen your type?
Yep.
Tell us why. Why is Galen your type? Tell us why. We want to know.
Because he's skinny.
You like the skinny boys.
Mm-hmm.
What you going to do with the skinny boys?
Fiend, I'm thick.
Let us see how thick you are, Denard.
Oh, yes.
Lamont.
Let us see. We can't see. We can't see. We can't prop that.
Hold on. It's been a moment, okay? I'm feeling real spontaneous.
Are you? Yes. Let us see. Let us see. Yes.
You better work, Denard.
I got a lot to hold on to.
where else are you thick, sir?
What happened?
I said, where else are you thick?
Around the cheeks.
Love that for you.
Yes!
I gotta get this one. I'm just saying, you live off Camp Creek?
I don't live off Camp Creek. That's just where I work.
Oh, you work all around there. Okay.
Yeah, that's just
I was around there not too long ago.
Okay.
Now, Lathonia is pretty far compared to Camp Creek.
That's far.
Outside of the perimeter. You know, sometimes the kids don't mess with people outside the perimeter.
Mm-hmm. Like, I can camouflage if I need to.
What that mean?
Assimilate.
No, I'm saying distance. It's far AF.
Oh, shoot. I work in Dunwoody.
So you can be all over the place, huh?
I am.
You better.
Yeah, I'm very adventurous.
How adventurous? The people want to know.
If you only knew.
We don't know. That's why we asking, bro.
Like, I like to try new things. I'm very spicy.
I can't tell. How spicy are you?
I think a 9.
Give us an example of your 9 spiciness.
You gotta find somebody spicy for this one, Lamont.
Apparently.
You gotta find some spice for him.
He skirted around it. We don't know how spicy
spice
you are.
Spice and adventure. Come on. Right. You gotta help him out, Lamont.
Oh,
what's
you
the
really
spiciest
want to know?
Thing you have done, okay?
What is the spiciest thing I've done? What's the spiciest thing I haven't done? That's the question.
Oh, child, you skirted around the issue. We ain't playing with you.
Well, okay, like, you know, I like having fun out. I like fucking outside.
In the parks?
Yes.
Oh, you be over at Grant Park.
Oh no, I don't do that anymore. But I used to love fucking in the park.
What about Piedmont?
Not Piedmont. I haven't done that.
What park you be at?
What park you be at?
I forgot what park it was. It was a long time ago.
It ain't been that long ago.
You know what? You ain't shit. Okay.
People have told me that. I'm okay with that. But I know it ain't been that long. You been at Sykes Park?
Maybe.
That's a yes.
I ain't heard of that one.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know nothing about that park play. I don't know nothing about that.
Yeah.
Be safe out there.
Nice to meet you.
Be safe out there in those streets, okay?
It's nice to meet you, too. Mm-hmm.
Good night.
Good night.
Denard trying to take you to the park. He trying to take you to the park. He trying to get
you
arrested.
You play too much.
Okay? He trying to get you arrested.
Now look, I'm all for some adventure. I'm all for some, you know, for some fun times, but.
Yeah, you trying to hang out in Fulton County Jail?
Mm-mm. No, that's where, yeah,
like,
I draw the line.
Get somebody else to do it. Corey has a question.
I had to save you. Because there was no way I was going to let that happen to you like that. Really?
Thank you. Thank you.
Bro, I was the one going, nah, 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 nah. Nah, nah, nah.
And Lamont is making just having a Lamont egging it on.
In his memory, I'm looking like, Lamont, you know you cannot do that to that man.
Look, that man said
top, but he said bottom. And that man looked at him and said, sister, honey, wife, don't do that.
He said he want a slim guy. He said he's slim. He like it.
I like slim too.
you like slim, but you look, don't lie to yourself. You want a solid thick. You want somebody that's about 5'10", 190, 183 at least.
They can break slim your back. Corey's slim over there.
No, I'm only a solid 170. Let's not do that. You know me. And I already got problems. Look, I got problems. You know, I got trust issues. Jesus, I'm an Aries. You know, once we get trust issues, it's over. It's a wrap. No, but I'm Corey. I'm sorry. I'm from Atlanta. Well, hi, I live Corey. In Atlanta. All right, what's up?
Where is this echo coming from? Who has the TV on in the background?
That's probably my black ass, because I was trying to put you on. Look, I was trying to put you on a telly because I had a whole bunch of people here that were here. But after 12 o'clock, I was like, y'all got to get the fuck out.
on a Wednesday night? What kind of party y'all get?
Ain't that kind of, Lamont, why it got to be that kind of party?
I asked what kind of party it was.
He was just asking what kind of party it was.
Thank you, Galen.
Oh, no, it was just like, they just wanted to come. I launched the thing for my body butter. And
okay, body butter.
But you know, I'm in IT for cybersecurity. You know that.
Yeah.
So.
And the balloons. And the balloons.
I don't know where they came.
Thank you. Y'all had Bible study on Wednesday. That's what they said.
look, I don't know. Look, I'm just here for the ride. But no, I had to save him. Look, Aries had to save Aries because he was just looking like.
Thank you, Corey. Thank you so much. Thank you. All right, see you later. You spin it over too. You spin it, Corey. You spin. Let me get to these questions though, Galen. You know, people trying to holler at you. You know, Ollie from Lithonia. You might have to put a picture of that man's face at your restaurant in case they show up and you know want to be in your section.
Well, hey, I just said I worked there. I didn't say when I worked there. So you know, hopefully I can remain some form of I can keep some form of anonymity.
No, they showing up. They coming to the Camp Creek Red Lobster and be like, put me in Galen's section. Where he at?
Ooh, child. Hey, well, if you're gonna tip right, come on.
Nah, you know how the gays are. They gonna run that ass around.
Look, as long as you tipping, that's all that matters.
They as bad as the church ones. Like, yeah. All right. So do you want to get married? Do you want to have children?
Yes. I am open to marriage and kids, at least one, no more than three.
Okay. What's a good age range? Like, what's the youngest? What's the oldest you'll go?
I think youngest 25, oldest 45.
Okay. Does the guy have to live in Atlanta?
For foundations, yes.
Okay.
For the beginnings, yes. I think I can entertain long distance after a solid foundation has been created. But yeah, I'm also not really in a position to be able to like travel like that. I mean, unless they're like within like an hour or two drive, maybe, but.
Like Lithonia? Like Lithonia?
Like Smyrna, like Jonesboro,
like Roswell, maybe McDonald's. Like Roswell,
Dunwoody, Alpha, you know, within the perimeter, if not on the very outskirts.
Listen, y'all don't understand. The Atlanta culture is if you live outside of the perimeter, they throw you shade. They be like, oh, you live where? I ain't driving way out there. Like,
right. Yeah. Right. And trust me, I get it. I'm outside of the perimeter myself. So, you know.
So that they'll be like, I ain't coming way up there. Yep. Okay.
Yeah. Nah.
So you prefer Atlanta, but they don't live there. Maybe not. What about race? What do you prefer?
I prefer black or of color. Black. But, yeah.
Stockbridge.
But yeah, I'm also open to like, you know. Say what?
Is Stockbridge too far?
Is that like southeast?
It's south. It's far. It's far AF.
South. Yeah,
it's
yeah. So maybe not Stockbridge. Fayetteville. I'll go as far as Fayetteville.
She far too, but it's okay.
Yeah.
Okay. What about body type? What do you like, Galen?
I think as far as body goes, I like proportionate. ideal situation, someone who has a similar body to me, or it's just someone who prioritizes not necessarily like fitness and like gym life, but like someone who prioritizes like, you know, activity, physical activity.
You like a guy who's fit, who's active. Yeah.
Yeah.
Now, what about like monogamy, open relationships, agreements? What you like?
I think I would say 9 times out of 10, probably not monogamous. However, I think I had a planned answer for this, but now that you asked the question, I actually have a change. It's not that I'm against monogamy. Monogamy is just gonna have to look a very specific way for me in order for me to be monogamous. So I just say that like non-monogamous, but as in like primary partner,
mm-hmm.
Healthy, ethical non-monogamy.
That was a very political answer.
Yeah.
So you prefer an open relationship that is a lot of communication where you all communicate about what y'all want.
Yeah. But I mean, like primary partner, like, you know, I think it's like, I feel like I can be successful monogamous as well as non-monogamous, and who and where we fall on the spectrum is going to depend on the person, you know, like if, for example, if I find myself like attracted to somebody who's like verse, automatically it's going to have to be non-monogamous, because it's like until we can like sort of figure out like what.
Yeah, because you're not giving up the cakes that often. So it's not going
to. Not immediately. Nah. Yeah. Yeah. Or yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
But you all, my friend Bruce is watching. His Instagram handle is Dr. Wu 1911. We're throwing him a house party in Atlanta this weekend. I'll make a big old flyer about it. We're going to do old school. Invite everybody in Atlanta to show up. We'll see how if it gets shut down. But you know, he's coming to Atlanta. So he's right there. I tagged him.
Okay.
Any single people, I tagged them. Okay. He's single. Hit him up. Okay. Questions y'all got for Galen. Let's see. What questions y'all got for Galen? Let's see what questions they got. What does a date night look like for you?
Date night looks like something fun, something like, actually there's a fair in town. I would love to go to the fair for a date night. As well as like, you know, I like non-conventional dates. Like I want to go like axe throwing. I want to go to putt shack. You know, I like doing like fun, like kind of competitive type things. I mean, I'm like a naturally competitive person. So like bowling, game nights, those type of things. But I also like, you know, I agreed heavily with what you said earlier about like dates, like a first date being like a dinner date and it being like an interview.
Mm-hmm.
And it's just like, I think we can like get to dinner later on. That's like date three or number four. But like the first one's about to be like something where I can see your personality shine through.
Something definitely, a lot of fun.
Yeah, yeah. Okay. I want to prioritize fun in the beginning, you know?
We have another question for you. Hello.
Hello. My name is Kwame. So I wanted to ask a question, because you said that you was an actor. So I wanted to know, like, how difficult do you find it, like, dating people that support and understand your acting ambitions?
That's a great question. Hey, Kwame. I think that if you have no idea or a very small idea of like what the life of an actor looks like, it can be really difficult to try to explain that to somebody, because like, you know, I think that the outside perception is that like actors are just like, you know, oh, like we get these cool opportunities to like, you know, meet famous people or like, you know, do these things or go here or go there. But like an actor's life is actually kind of all up and over the place, you know. As much as you have like, you know, you have highs, but then you have a lot of lows too. And mm-hmm. so like, you know, and sometimes you can't always like, you know, not sometimes you can't, but sometimes it can be difficult to like, you know, support yourself, or it can be difficult to like, you know, sort of stay afloat. And so I think sometimes a lot of people get sort of not, I guess, like turned off, or like, you know, they don't really understand like you know, how a grown person is like sort of living and surviving and you're not like working actively like in your thing. So, but for me, I don't know. I kind of feel like as long as you can understand or like just at least support, like, you know, if I'm in a show, wanting to at least come and see the show is like a green flag as opposed to like a red flag is like not really caring or not really interested or not wanting to support, you know? So, yeah, I'll say it's difficult, but like, you know, those who it matters to, it matters to. Those who it doesn't matter to, it doesn't matter to. So,
yeah. And Kwame, you're in Atlanta, right?
Yes.
Okay. Does Galen seem like your type?
He does, actually. He does. From at least from what we've, from what I've, you know, heard thus far.
Yeah.
So, yeah.
Well, hit me up, Kwame. Yeah.
Slide in his DM. Say hello. Take him on a date. Okay.
Will do.
Oh, keep me posted. All right. See you, Kwame. Listen, Gayla, you're going to be going on some dates. Okay.
I'm open to it.
You got some outfits? You got outfits? You got enough? You know, you got a look or two?
Yeah. Oh yeah. 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 We whenever, you know, whenever we go out in public is getting cute. So that I'm not worried about.
Okay. Let's see what other questions they got for you. Let's see. How do you take care of the booty when you're in it?
I am definitely one to take my time. I'm definitely more of a sensual top. I know that you know, I'm on the girthier side, so I understand that it might take things a little while to open up. So I really let the bottom lead, you know. It's like it's not really about like me in that moment getting my thing. It's really about like making sure that I'm the receiving end that they're taken care of and that, you know, I sort of like follow their lead.
Oh. So look, you let the bottom take the lead.
Yeah.
Until you get open up and then you just go all the way in.
Yeah, I feel like I do a good job of listening to the body. You know, I can tell like when it's like tense, and I can tell when it's like give it to me. So you know, so yeah.
All right, let's see what other questions. How difficult has it been dating people who understand and support your acting ambitions?
I mean, I wouldn't necessarily say it's difficult. To be honest, I kind of feel like guys don't really stay around that long to even get that deep, you know, with me. Like guys don't really stick around that long to like, you know, to one, find out that like I'm an actor, and two, like to find out or know or inquire about like what difficulties I'm facing.
You don't hear that in the first date, like, hey, you know, I'm in acting or whatever.
I mean, if they ask me, yeah, you know, but I feel like people just really get like caught up in like the physical and like, they really just want to like, you know, fuck at the end of the day. So we never really like dive in deep to like those things of like, oh, like, what are your career goals? Or like, what ambitions do you have? Or like, you know, what do you do? Like what? So yeah, I don't know. I can't say that I've had any difficulty with it because like people don't really get that far.
Okay. They're like, Lamont, he answered that question already. Why are we going back to that? Whatever, people. I guess it was there. It was there. Thank you. It was there. Yeah, I'm too much. All right. Back up. You got to turn around so we can see you head to toe.
Okay. Let's see. Turn up.
Back up. You good.
Okay.
They said send your news to Tyler Perry as soon as possible. All right, you all. This is Galen. Galen lives in Atlanta. He's 32, 5'11", 173 pounds. He is an Aries team top. He's an actor, also a server at Red Lobster. We're not going to say a location. Y'all can find out. Y'all look at the video from earlier. Open to getting married and having children. He will date between 25 and 45. Prefers that you live in Atlanta. Okay. Not in Lithonia. That's too far.
Not in Lithonia.
Not in like Dallas, Georgia, like in the perimeter-ish. Okay.
ITP, please.
Prefers black guys or guys of color. He said someone who's more proportionate, slim, kind of like his body type. And then non-monogamous. Yeah, I got to work that thing out. Tell us your, he is not showing you all the girth. It is not that type of show, people. This is not OnlyFans. Go on Twitter or X, which is called now, and y'all can follow y'all people and y'all can see their stuff, okay? But no, he's looking for a man. He's looking for love, okay? Don't be approaching him on no fuckboy shit, okay? I know I'm cussing, but whatever. Don't approach him on that vibe. If you approach him on that vibe, guess what's going to happen? He will block you and delete you. He wants to go on a date with someone who actually appreciates him, okay?
But if you're cute, I got time.
That was if not you're cute and that ass fat, I got time. Okay? It is cupping season, okay? If you spend your time on these fuckboys, you will not find your husband, okay?
That's true. That is true.
That was in the summertime, okay? Summertime. Yeah. It is time to focus on a man that you want to be with, okay?
Time to get some cuddles. Yeah. Some cuddles.
You're going to be alone on Christmas with no matching pajamas, if not.
And I deserve that this year, so.
Yes.
Amen.
Tell them your Instagram handle and spell it, okay?
Once more, my Instagram handle is @TheGalenJWilliams. That is THEE. GALENJWILLIAMS. Almost forgot how to spell my last name for a second.
All right, Galen, thanks for coming on the show tonight.
Thanks a lot. Tell me about this party on Saturday. I might pull up.
I will DM me. I'll send it to you. Yes. I'm making a flyer, so I have to send it out to people. Yes.
All right.
All right.
Bye.
Bye. All right, what y'all think of Galen? Go ahead and rank him. You think he's dateable? Put a 10. If not, put a 1. Yeah, we have been on here for 2 hours and almost 40 minutes. We've been on here for a minute. Somebody said, you're going to be busy. Oh, really, Darius? You take him on a date? Okay. What y'all think? Is he dateable? Is he not? What y'all think? I see 9s, 10s. Jonathan, why'd you give that man a 4? Why? I just want to know why. Why? Why? Hey, Phil. An 8. Bruce, when are you coming on the show? Bruce, you be in the comment section all the time. When are you coming on the show? I see a 10s, 10s, 8s, 9s. Bulldog, 39. Why a 5? Why a 5? If you gave him less than a 7, I need to know why. I didn't know why. Why? Why? Then I don't count things. You just got here, so you can't vote. You can't vote. 4 is hating. 4 is hating. I feel like anything under a 7 is hating. Like why? Why? Nick, I will come to you, Nick. Let's see if you can come on, Nick. Let's see. Let's see. Y'all gotta buy more badges if we keep going. Hello, 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 hello.
Hey, how's it going?
I am doing awesome. How you doing? Lift that hat up. We can't see your face.
Okay, is that better? Yes, no, maybe so. Should I turn it backwards? I can turn it backwards so you guys see my face more.
Yeah, it's fine. It's fine. We can see your face. We can see your face. We can see your face.
Okay.
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 All right. How you doing tonight?
I'm good. How are you?
I am doing awesome. It's National Coming Out Day. It's the late night edition, so we're having a good time.
Okay.
Is your name Nick?
It is, yes. My name is Nick.
Nick, are you a shooter?
Yes, I am.
What is a shooter?
A shooter is somebody that, when you're about to bust, it doesn't ooze out, it shoots.
No. The name of the show is Shoot Your Shot Wednesday.
Well, I didn't know where your mind was, so I just had to. Anywho, yes, I am a shooter. Yes. Yes.
You will be a shooter at once you finish this one, okay?
Okay.
Oh, somebody said they can vouch for you. They can vouch that you are a shooter.
Okay.
You got people giving you Yelp reviews?
We're going to run with it.
All right, Nick. Where do you live, Nick?
Okay, so I live in Atlanta.
Okay, ATL announced a lot of people from Atlanta tonight. How old?
I'm not from, wait, hold on, let's backtrack. Not from Atlanta, just live in Atlanta.
Where are you from, Nick?
I'm from New Orleans.
Okay, you're from New, how long have you been in Atlanta?
About 3 years.
Three years? Okay, okay. How old are you?
I'm 30.
30, okay. How tall are you and about how much do you weigh?
So I'm 5'8 and I am approximately 177.
It sounds like you weigh yourself pretty often.
Yeah, because I'm big into the gym. I work out like 6 days a week, so I have to.
How often do you weigh yourself?
Like every like 2.5-3 months.
Oh, that's not often. That's not often. I'm thinking like you weighing yourself every like day or every other day.
Oh, no. I really just recently weigh myself more because I'm going into bulking season. So I used to be very toned, but now I'm like out of the toning range, so that's great. So I've typically been weighing myself just to make sure I'm staying on track with that.
What's your goal? You're at 177. What's the goal?
So my goal, honestly, is I don't want to be too much bigger. So I really want to be like 185. I feel like would be perfect for me. So I'm not too far from that goal, which is great. So
go to Waffle House late at night. You'll get there. You'll do that. You won't do that. You thought I wouldn't
do that. No, absolutely not. No, I'll be paying for it in the morning. So.
Okay. What's your zodiac sign?
I'm an Aquarius.
Okay. Aquarius in the house. Are you a January Aquarius or February Aquarius?
January.
Okay. Y'all okay. You know, y'all okay. Now, you team, don't worry about the comments, sir. Nick, don't worry about the comments, okay?
Okay.
My eyes are right here. Look at me. Okay. Okay. All right. We doing your interview. We're going to find... Are you serious about dating? You want to find a guy?
I am, yes, definitely.
Okay, all right. So, now, are you team top, bottom, verse, side? How do you get down?
Verse.
Let's do the calculation, okay? So, okay. Nick, in the last 12 months, what percentage did you top? What percentage did you bottom? Last 12 months.
So, honestly, last 12 months, it truly has been half and half, honestly.
About half and half?
Yes.
Okay. So just given verse, what type of work do you do?
So I'm actually a personal trainer. I am a cheer coach. So I'm pretty much like a jack of all trades. I mean, I kind of do it all, really.
Okay. Why y'all call the man a bottom? He said that he 50% of the time he verse. I mean,
you know what's crazy is I get that all the time. So it's not even like a big deal. I just kind of like.
A man take dick one time, he a bottom for the rest of his life.
That's pretty much how. That's how it is, literally here in Atlanta. So
that doesn't make any sense. It doesn't make any sense. It does not make any sense, people. It does not. Okay.
No.
Versatility does exist among gay men. I'm just saying. Okay. Tell them your Instagram handle and spell it.
Okay, so I have two. I have a personal page.
No, do the one that we're on now.
Okay, cool. So it is Nick Fit. So it's NICKFIT 504.
All right, you all. This is Nick. Nick is reading the comments. He lives in Atlanta. He's 30 years old, 5'8", 177 pounds. He's an Aquarius, team verse, and he's a personal trainer. Okay. They said, Lamont, calm down. We just playing. Now, I do get excited sometimes. If y'all have questions for Nick, wave. You can come on. Or hit the question function, and you can ask those questions, okay? Now, Nick, what makes you a good catch?
Okay, so for me, what makes me a good catch is that I'm very... I want to say one thing I am. I'm very, communicative. Like, I'm big on communication, so... and I'm very intuitive, intellectual. And I just feel like I know what I want, so I'm not here for games. So, yeah, that's what kind of makes me
a good catch is that I know what I want. So when I see it, I go after it. I don't hide behind the bushes. You know, I kind of go for what I want. So
what's the longest relationship you've been in?
I've been like 3.5 years.
Okay. Did y'all live together?
We did.
Oh, nice, nice. Now, do you want to get married? Do you want to have children?
I do. I do want to get married. I do want to have 2 beautiful kids.
2 kids. Okay. Does the guy you date, does he have to live in Atlanta?
He does not have to live in Atlanta. If you would have asked me a couple years ago, I would have said yes. But now, as we all know how the dating scene is here in Atlanta, I'm not opposed of it.
What do you think about the dating scene in Atlanta?
I'm sorry, say it again.
What do you think about the dating scene in Atlanta?
The dating scene in Atlanta is trash.
Why is it trash? Literally. Why do you say that?
I mean, honestly, because I just feel like guys here don't know what they want. And I think for me is that I do know what I want. I know what it looks like. I know what it feels like. And here in Atlanta, guys are just really big on, they're stuck on what you look like and what you could do for them. But it's not, it's deeper than that. I feel like it's more about what happened to old fashioned, like, let's go to the walk, like walk a park, like let's go have a picnic at the park, like let's go to Publix and maybe we get like fruits and a bottle of wine. Mm-hmm. Like I'm very old school. I have an old soul. So that's kind of like what I like. Mm-hmm. But that's not what the guys here are about.
So. I respectfully disagree. I think Atlanta is a great city to date in. There are a lot of eligible single gay men, particularly a lot of successful Black gay men who want relationships. And I think sometimes people see that there are a lot of options. There are a lot of clubs. There's like all this stuff to do. And they get sucked into that. But there are guys who are like, oh, I'm not into that. I'm looking for love. So I think it's the Atlanta scene is better. The most marketable city or place to date for a Black gay man. It's better than Jackson, Mississippi. It's better than New York. It's better than D.C. It's better than Chicago. There are more options here.
So I will respectfully agree with you. But the part why I disagree is that maybe I've never... what you're describing, I've never experienced that. Mm-hmm. Because I do feel like I would be in a long-term relationship right now if I had experienced that. So, yeah. I mean, I would love to endeavor and experience that, but yeah. Unfortunately, I have not. So
I think it just depends on what network you're in, like what your circle looks like. And then if you change it, and then you might experience something different. Someone said, single, gay, and successful does not equal eligible. I agree. I think the person also has to be emotionally aware, have core values as well. I'm just saying, there are some cities where the guys are not successful. They're struggling. They live with their mother. They got 10 roommates. They don't know what they want. They're still in the closet. I think Atlanta is a city where people are out of the closet. And they're open about who they are. That's all I'm saying.
I just moved into my place too, by the way. So yeah.
You what?
Today. I just moved into my place today.
Oh, so. Congratulations. Congratulations.
Yes. Yes, exactly.
You're christening your place today. Yes.
Yes, exactly. So
what's a good age range? What's the youngest you would go? What's the oldest?
So the youngest that I would go would be like 28, 29. Mm-hmm. The oldest, I would say, like, the oldest that I've dated was, like, 50. Okay. Because a lot of older guys, I attract a lot of older guys because I can hold a conversation. I can disengage and put my phone down for an hour or two on a date. I think that's a big thing here in Atlanta, too, is that when I date, I don't know, I'm looking at all these things, you know, when we go on a date, can you disengage from your phone for a minute or are you always like this? Granted, the flip side to that is when you are dating somebody, business, it could be business related, correct? Right. But at the same time, it's just like, when we're on a date, can your phone like...
Yeah, and put it aside. Yeah, put it aside. Exactly. Let's focus. Yeah. Okay. What about body type? What you like, Nick?
So I would like somebody that's kind of like into fitness like myself, mm-hmm. because I mean, like I said, I've been into fitness since I was 8. Yeah, I've always been in the fitness arena. So I would like somebody that's big into fitness because, you know, that's not going anywhere. So
mm-hmm. you have a preference for race?
I don't actually. I've just recently opened up my horizons to all races because, again, if we're just staying in the box and we're just accustomed to one thing, then we may miss out on our option on that great guy. So I've opened that horizon over the last year and a half. So
okay. Now, do you like more monogamy, open relationships, agreements? What you like?
So I'm definitely big on monogamy for sure. I'm very selfish. That's just not for me. I know people that, you know, it whatever works for them, but I know for me, definitely monogamy for sure.
Okay. All right. So if y'all got questions for Nick, use the chat function. If you want to come on and ask him a question, wave, and I'll bring you on. Let's see what questions they got for you. I don't understand this. Let's see. Let's see what questions they got for you.
Somebody come up. Don't be scared to come up if you got to ask me a question.
Jonathan wants to know, can you make your box stretch and what makes your pound town wet?
Okay. So as far as making my box stretch, I'm going to have to say no because I'm actually not open at all. And what makes me wet is honestly somebody that can hold a conversation. I'm not typical. I know some people are like, oh, thick size and all that. That's great. But what turns me on the most is someone that can get up here, prime example, get up here on this platform right now, talk to me, hold a conversation. That's what turns me on more than anything.
You like confidence.
Oh, yeah, most definitely.
Yeah.
Confident, not being cocky.
Yeah.
Love confidence.
Yeah, yeah. Okay, let's see what other questions they got for you. Let's see. Why did you want to move to Atlanta?
Okay, so I went to school in New Orleans, and when Hurricane Katrina hit, I ended up moving from Louisiana to Texas, where I was living in Austin for about a year and a half. And then I moved to Atlanta for better job opportunities. And both of my parents got even better jobs here in Atlanta. So yeah, that's why I'm here in Atlanta now.
Okay. All right, let's see what other questions. They said, do you sing, Nick? Do you sing?
Yes, I can sing, but no, I'm not singing tonight.
What type of music do you typically sing?
I like R&B.
Okay. Like you perform live?
No, not live, but I can hold a tone.
Okay. Yes, for a tone. I can't hold a tone. I get the wrong words and I'm loud. So don't ask me to sing anything.
Right.
Are you a competitor or aspiring to compete? I don't know what that
means. Yes. I am a competitor. And it goes back to my cheerleading and gymnastics days. I've always kind of been that way. So yes, very competitive. Yeah.
Okay. Let's see. One more question. Oh, those are for people. Oh, that was from the previous one. Okay. So you got to back up, turn around so we can see you. Okay.
Okay. Tell me to stand up or what?
Yeah. You got to stand up, back up so we can see you head to toe.
Okay.
And give us a little spin. All right, you all, this is Nick. Nick lives in Atlanta. He's 35'8". He is 177 pounds. He's Aquarius, Team Verse. He's a personal trainer. He's open to getting married and having children. You can live in any city. He's open to that. He will date between 28 and 50, prefers someone who is fit, open to race, and he prefers monogamy, people. Tell them your Instagram handle one more time and spell it for us, Nick.
Okay, my Instagram handle is NickFit504. That is NickFit504.
So I'm sure you're going to be inundated with messages on Instagram. Okay. I want you to go on at least 2 dates.
Okay.
Like in person, like, okay, talk on the phone first, make sure they're not crazy. And then,
yeah, because like, a lot of them are crazy.
Right, right. Make sure they're not, you know, married or like trying to, you know, steal your liver or anything like that. And be like, okay, let's meet somewhere to go for a walk or hike or hang out. At least 2 guys, okay?
Yes. Hopefully, okay, never mind. I'm gonna keep it cute. Yes, okay. Yes, so people are saying, what? You're eating up those shorts. Yeah, the gym is doing me right.
Thanks for coming on, Nick.
Thank you.
All right, good night.
All right, good night.
All right. Okay. What did you all think of Nick? What did y'all think of Nick? We've been on here for almost 3 hours. Go ahead and rank this man, because I think I'm done. I think I'm done. I know there are a bunch of people in the queue, but next week we'll get y'all, okay? I want all 200 of you all to rank him. What do you think? Is he dateable? Is he not? What'd you think? I see 10s. Okay. Why y'all ranking him? So listen, if you live in New York City, I do have some clients that I'm trying to match in New York City. So if you are single and you are like serious about looking for love, not on some bullshit, DM me. We'll talk. I got some clients in New York that I'm trying to match. Okay. Yes. Thank you all for the badges. I appreciate the support so much. I appreciate it. You know, I come up here every Wednesday night. Every Wednesday. I could be doing other things on a Wednesday night. Okay. Other things on a Wednesday night. But I like hanging out with y'all. Even if I'm in like a different city. I still come up on a Wednesday night. Okay? Darius, like, keep going. We've been on here for 3 hours, sir. 3 hours. We're not doing a marathon. I know some of y'all like marathons, but it's not going to happen. All right. So I will see you all next week. Have a great night. Deuces.